Welcome to Sevens Friday Night Football. It's a sellout, and why not? It's a massive occasion with a big, big build-up. The battle of the unbeatens. The Bombers have swept the board, but tonight they take on the might of the Cats.
They're the powerhouse of the competition. Six consecutive seasons in the final eight. Five top four finishes. Three flags. And even when the premiership window should be closing, Geelong is born again.
Long ball, great ball!
With bold, creative talent. Former bit players who are sparking new life.
You are a marvel!
And old champs relishing the battle more than ever.
Here is Enright. Look at the celebration!
Geelong is the club that others envy. Essendon has built a unit based on the Geelong model. Bigger, stronger bodies going hard at the football. Ruthless offenders moving the ball with razor-like precision. And they've become merciless in attack.
Essendon are going in for the kill right now.
The two clubs sit side by side at the top of the ladder. Six wins from six games. And tonight, we find out how far the Bombers have come. Whether they can match it mentally and physically.
Oh, what a finish!
Whether they can pass the acid test against the envy of the competition. This is Friday Night Football.
And in a couple of hours, there'll be just one unbeaten team. I'm with Nick Riewoldt tonight, Tom Harley and Lee Matthews.
Fantastic occasion when two unbeaten teams. You get to round seven. Just reminds me, round 14, 2009, when St Kilda and Geelong were both undefeated. And we're joined by two guys who were inside the white line that day, of course. Bruce, Tom and Nick.
Well, it was the most intense game of football I reckon I've played, and that includes finals. When the roof's shut here, the atmosphere is amazing, and that was something else, Nick.
Yeah, a lot of conjecture about whether this game should have been played at the MCG. I'm personally really happy that it's played here. Conditions aren't going to be a factor. It's a hard track and the skills are going to be great for a great game of footy.
No doubt about that, Nick. Let's go up to you, Dennis.
Well, the best thing about Geelong, apart from their three premierships in six seasons, is their ability to reinvent themselves. After time near the top, the Bulldogs and the Saints have fallen on hard times, but these Cats keep on rolling on. Alan Christensen, coming off 28 possessions and three goals last week, is a case in point. After 42 games, he's becoming a star in a midfield that has consistently dominated the Bombers. So much so, Joe Watson has never polled a Brownlow vote against Geelong. With 47 games, ruckman Trent West is another big improver. Look no further than 31 hitouts last Saturday night. He seems to love responsibility. Of course, reinvention is all well and good, but Lee, I guess it helps to have some great role models.
Well, absolutely. It's just amazing. There's only seven players playing tonight that played in that 2007 grand final team. So the regeneration of the Geelong side, we see them listed. I mean, they're virtually household names these days, but so many new players have come in, and there's eight players tonight who haven't played in any of the three premierships. So regenerating, being undefeated. But I think the first-year player in 2007 was Joel Selwood. I saw an incident last week when the Geelong played Richmond that showed his will, his determination and his strength. He said, "You're not beating me, Chris Newman." He just picked him up and dumped him. And I reckon that will to win is visibly demonstrated in that that wrestle that he won.
Had a feeling you'd like that, Lee. I mean, not only they can wrestle, Tom, they can wrest the lead off a team in a hurry.
Well, they've got a great ability, Bruce. You're absolutely right, to score goals and score them really quickly, often in red time. And it all started in the first round against the Hawthorn Footy Club. They were challenged, put the foot down, and particularly here at Etihad Stadium, I think, since 2007, the Cats are 25-5. As Nick touched on in the opener, it's a fast track, so they can score goals really quickly, and it's all throughout the season so far. But the Bombers, Nick, you've got to say, they're the rank one defensive side in the competition. They deny the opposition the ball. So if there is a side to stop a run on like this, it might be the Bombers tonight.
And that's a perfect storm, isn't it? A team that's capable of cutting you up so quickly and really putting a game to bed in the space of 15 to 20 minutes, coming up against a team that's ranked number one so far this season for defence.
It is interesting that both sides really make it very hard for the opposition forward line to mark the ball, have set shots. So that ability to stop them getting the ball in the air both defences are terrific at that.
And there's a huge amount of self-belief in those younger players that you spoke about, Lee, who haven't played in premierships, know what's expected when you come into this side. And it is usually started by the more experienced players when they put the foot down, but, geez, the young boys join in pretty quickly.
Let's go and join Cameron Ling and Tim Watson. Tim?
Well, Lingy, you know this side well, this Geelong side so well. How important is Boris Enright to this side?
Well, absolutely crucial to the team. And talking about another bloke who knows the team well, Mark Thompson, of course, assistant coach at Essendon. They would have spent a lot of time preparing to make sure that Corey Enright doesn't have an influence on tonight's game. I'm picking a Michael Hibbard or a Benny Howlett to get the job on him. It's got to be somebody who's really, really smart. Michael Hibbard's obviously spent a bit of time down back himself, but he's a really clever player. They need to make him accountable. They need to be able to draw the ball in dangerous parts, not run to dumb positions and allow him to sag off. They've got to stop his ball movement, his fast ball movement through the middle of the ground, the way he sets up the team. And all the Geelong defenders, they've got to make sure they're isolated. You can't have them helping each other out. They're so good at helping in the air, helping on the ground and outnumbering and running the ball away. If Essendon forward line really gets going tonight, they've got to do it one-on-one.
Let's take a look at that Essendon team. They've made six changes tonight. Fletcher and Carlisle come back into the side. Heppel's back into the side. Windelick too. But the really important inclusion in their forward line's Hurley. He would be, before he got injured, probably in the best form that I've seen him display in his AFL career. His touch was just wonderful. Lonergan generally goes to the gun forward, so I expect that he would go to him. Harry Taylor, I think, will go to Gumbledon. Now, he'll have his work cut out too. I know Harry's got a pretty big engine, but Gumbledon has been running about 15 or 16 Ks a game, and that leaves Cramery too as that third tall, and I'm expecting maybe Mackie will go to him, wouldn't he?
Well, it's probably going to be Andrew Mackie. He's probably the other one who can play tall, but Cramery's so good in the air, on the ground. He's a really hard matchup. Andrew Mackie's going to have to be right on his game tonight.
Thanks for that, Tim and Lingy. Well, Nick, you as a champion, St Kilda, big forward, know Harry Taylor so well. I mean, you've had so many battles against Geelong. Tell us a little bit about him.
I think his great strength is obviously his ability to mark the ball. So usually you come up against a key defender and at worst, they're spoiling the ball and equalising the contest. But as a forward, he really forces you to think about your positioning and to think differently in the way you attack the ball, just because he is so strong in the air, Tom.
Yeah, well, when he first came into the side, it was in 2008, and had some players around him, and we were taught as defenders, if you can see the ball, go and mark the ball. Spoiling was almost the last resort, and Harry's taken that to another level.
And for someone that attacks the ball so much, he's conceded only 3 goals for the season, which is a remarkable stat.
And imagine, it must put the pressure back on the forward, because, okay, if a spoil, the ball goes to the ground, but if he marks it, then they rebound it. It does make enormous difference the way you go about it.
Yeah, it does. It really turns the table on you mentally more than anything. You have to think harder about your positioning, and if the ball's in the air, you really, as a forward, just have to give a contest.
It's been an incredible year for Essendon. We know that some of their players have been interviewed by Asada this week. We know that that hasn't made any impact so far this season. What have they got in store tonight? I'm surprised Ryder's not playing tonight.
Well, when Scott Gumbledon would have been told that he was going to be the second ruckman, I think, one, I'm in the team, that's good. But I've never seen him jump for a ruck contest, so that's an enormous ask of him.
Absolutely. I mean, the modern game almost predicates that the second ruckman must be able to play forward. We know he can do that. Can he ruck? We know Ryder can, so it's interesting, Bruce.
I think he'll probably come up against Blitzovs in the ruck, so he's not a huge man, so that'll probably equalise that situation a little bit more than we think.
So Watson leads him out. I saw Fletcher a moment ago. He's just the third 38-year-old in 85 years to play.
He's mad. What's he doing?
Amazing.
Let's go down to Tim Watson with James here. Tim?
Well, James, the boys have just been talking about the fact that Paddy Ryder's not playing tonight. Gumbledon's the second ruckman. How much of the ruck are you expecting him to play tonight?
Oh, look, it'll depend on how Tommy's going, but, you know, probably 20 or 30%. Scott's did a lot of that work for us last year, so he knows what he's doing and provides a bit of extra run around the forward line as well.
He's up for the challenge?
Oh, definitely, yes. Scott's been waiting a long time to get consistent football in, and he really deserves his opportunity for the last 3 or 4 weeks.
Michael Hurley was in great touch before he got injured. Has he been displaying great touch on the training track as well since?
Yes, he has. We looked at playing him last week. He's probably had 10 days of really good training into him now, so his hands are good, his feet are good, so we're looking forward to a good performance by Michael.
Bomber Thompson knows his team really well, the Geelong team. How much input has he had during the week in the planning?
Yeah, quite a lot. I mean, Mark knows a lot of their more senior players, I suppose, and also the culture down there at Geelong, so knows how they want to play football. So he's always had a big input into the games, probably more so today.
I don't know if you break the game down like this, but Geelong are a really freewheeling, high-scoring side. How many goals do you think you're going to have to kick tonight to beat them?
It's more how many stop. You know, we'd like to keep them to a reasonable score and score ourselves, but, you know, I don't think anyone who plays Geelong can afford to have a freewheeling game, because they'll probably beat you in that style.
Good luck tonight.
Thanks, Tim. Ta-ta.
So interesting stuff there, James Hird. And there's Brendan Goddard, of course, an old teammate of yours, Nick, who's made a good start to his career as a Bomber. He's 6-0. He's done that with you, of course. I mean, you're the 13-0 in 2009, the match that Lee talked about. So the Cats are about to come out. Well, an interesting selection into Joel Selwood and Stevie Johnson. Those, that milestone, massive roar. And a few boos. It's a Geelong home game tonight. Two youngsters again, so they keep on picking the young ones, don't they?
And big raps on Thurlow. They've creative halfback in the Corey Enright, Joel Corey mould. So can't get bigger raps than that. Looking forward to seeing him play.
Let's go down to you, Cameron.
Well, Scotty, huge game of footy, big build-up to tonight's game. Dustin Fletcher back in for the Bombers. It's really crucial that you're able to engage him. He's just so good at sagging off and setting them up. How do you go about making sure that happens tonight?
Yeah, we've got to try to make it hard for him, which isn't easy because he defends sort of back 30 so well, but he can also push up the ground and be a damaging attacking player as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if he goes to a small, and you know, we'd be happy with that as well.
Another young player, Jackson Thurlow, getting his debut tonight. It's really exciting, isn't it, getting these young guys coming in, because they seem to be reinvigorating the whole team.
Yeah, it's exciting for our senior players, to be honest. I mean, we presented Jackson his jumper, and, you know, the older guys are just pumped about it. He's really been pushing his case for a number of weeks now, and we've wanted to get him in previously, but he's had to wait until tonight. He'll do well.
We know the midfield's always crucial in a game of footy, but some very, very fascinating matchups potentially. Selwood versus Watson, maybe Taylor Hunt, Zaharakis. How do you see that one going?
Taylor Hunt's going to play back tonight, so we think his attack out of a back half is just as important as the defensive job he does. We're going to trust Steve Johnson and James Kelly and Joel Selwood, so pretty much go head-to-head with their guys and back ours against theirs.
Appreciate your time, mate. All the best.
No worries. Thanks.
Now, that is what you call a feel-good interview. A lot of mutual respect there. As we set up the scene, the stage is set. Two undefeated sides on a big night, Friday night football. Jared Watson, as we mentioned earlier, never a Brownlow vote against these Cats. And that guy is having a terrific season, closing down players and finding the footy. Taylor Hunt, another Taylor. Harry is back there as well in defence. One of the defenders of his generation. And a fortnight ago, he went forward and kicked five goals against the Western Bulldogs. Versatile to boot, eh? Friday night football. We're hot to trot. Geelong and Essendon. Tonight, there will be a loser. Tonight at Etihad Stadium. Two undefeated sides, Geelong and Essendon. Geelong with wins over Hawthorn, North Melbourne, Carlton, Sydney, the Western Bulldogs and Richmond, and the Bombers over Adelaide, Melbourne, Fremantle, St Kilda, Collingwood and GWS. Fair to say the Cats might have the better resume as we go down to Tim Watson on the bump.
Well, Dennis, really warm conditions down here too. We know that we've had some warm weather during the week here in Melbourne, around the mid-20s, but still 24 degrees in the stadium at the moment. And a massive roar for the Geelong side when they ran out tonight. They got lots of supporters here tonight, Lingy.
Yeah, huge night, great atmosphere for footy. Two unbeaten teams, as we've spoken about. Massive crowd. I think everybody's really excited. And that man on screen there, Joe Watson, he'll play a big part in tonight's game. Chris Scott did just give me the quiet little mention that Steve Johnson's the man who's going to have the job on Joe, which is a massive challenge, and not one that Steve has necessarily done too often in his career. So that'll be a really interesting one to watch tonight, Tim.
And no barracking from you either.
No, none from you either, mate. We'll stay very calm down here, Dennis. Don't worry.
Good on you, Cam. Toss of the coin.
That's a Cats. Yep.
Joel Selwood wins the toss. First blood then for the Cats. The umpires tonight, Rosebery, Stevic and Ryan. A couple of first gamers for Geelong tonight too. Jordan Schroeder and Jackson Thurlow. Cam, what can you tell us about those guys?
Oh, a great deal about Jackson Thurlow, other than watching a little bit of training. He's a very quick Tasmanian kid. They absolutely love him down there. Jordan Schroeder, I got to play a season with him. He's a hard-nosed, in-and-under type player who's just really worked on his game at VFL level. Hopefully those two really enjoy their game tonight. Of course, Schroeder starting as a sub. He won't get into it straight away, but what a debut, what a game to debut in.
What a mix this is, too. Experience and youth now, Geelong. Reinventing themselves, as we said, so impressively. But a test tonight, Essendon against all the odds. Boys up from downstairs. Most impressive, that new set, Bruce, I've got to say. It looked good.
Thank you.
That's how you and I will be remembered in years to come, I reckon. Half man, half desk.
You were just talking about Geelong. I mean, think of the five players who haven't played 10 games, another seven who haven't played 50. Either their recruiting is unbelievable or the development system is sensational. Or maybe both, because it's just amazing the youth in the team and still undefeated.
Well, you like those role models, Lee, and they've had plenty of them.
They've certainly had them, yeah. But other clubs have had role models, but they haven't been able to maintain that premiership window for this is their seventh year they've been in that.
Who do you think will win, Lee?
Well, I actually fancy Essendon a little bit. I mean, it's a toss of a coin, but that was because I thought Bell, James and Ryder might be just quite dominating in the ruck contest, but Essendon's choosing to go with more or less a fill-in second ruckman, better forward than Lily Gumbleton, I think. It means that Ryder obviously is emergency, so that helps a little bit the Geelong ruckman, who are probably still a bit B-grade-ish in terms of what they've performed at this point.
So the subs tonight, Robert Murray for the Bombers, Jordan Schroeder for the Geelong Cats, playing his second game. Cam, quick to point that out. Here with him last year. He'll benefit from that experience, I'm sure. As we start this game then, the rucks go at it, one down by Bell Chambers. First kick of the game, blanketed, came from Goddard. Heppel falling to the ground, Bagley deflects it across to Zaharakis, who kicks a high one down towards half forward. Harry's in the road though, well played by Taylor, thumped it down. Lonigan hand passes up in the air. Heppel lost the footy. Cramery tackled about 55 metres out, and the umpire will ball it up. Nick Riewoldt made the point, no excuses tonight in terms of the conditions out there. Bell Chambers, the hurried kick forward, plenty of cats at the drop. Well done by Taylor. That was a terrific grab. Plenty of courage there. They were coming from all angles. They were going to meet at the footy. Harry just eyes for the football. Smets a little 1-2, and again with Motlop. Clever kick by Motlop. Gave it to Stokes. Hand passes forward. Down goes Lonigan. Loose ball picked up by Ryder. Goes to Watson. Upended. Umpire will call for this one inside the centre square.
Great tackle by Johnson there. Gee, he was quick on to Joe Watson.
Might be one to watch, Bruce. I reckon Stevie Johnson spending a lot of time in the midfield, whether he actually spends a lot of time close to Joe Watson.
It looks like Taylor might have early, so Lonigan may go there.
Mackie's playing as the third tall for the Geelong defence also.
So Podziadli gets it from Johnson, and Geelong on the burst here. Smets, he's got a pretty good record against the Bombers, and that's a brilliant kick inside, and Blitzoff takes the mark. So they open them up there.
Come out the side, Brendan.
It's almost a respects thing, really. You've got Blitzarts, who's new to the game and not a goal kicker, obviously, and he shouldn't be allowed to get that much space in the defensive 50.
He didn't start in the ruck, did he? So, in fact, I don't think Bell Chambers is a direct opponent, but he slipped someone, probably Fletcher, I think, was a direct matchup going in.
So his only goal in his short career to date was last week against the Tigers, until now, an unlikely first goal score in the blockbuster.
I mean, he's almost a typical project player, Blitzart. He's been a really good foil in the ruck for the Cats going forward. He enjoyed that goal, that's for sure. And young Jackson Thurlow's also come onto the ground for his first run tonight.
Cats lead it by 6 points. Bell Chambers wins it down. Spills backward of the pack. Kelly onto the loose ball, in trouble. Gets a hand pass away. Johnson cleverly and again stumbles. Controls. Short one on the bounce to Kelly. Kelly directly to Zaharakis, the man who won the Anzac Day medal not so long ago. Outstanding performance against Collingwood. 34 possessions. He comes out very wide. Watson at the interchange gates.
Well, if Johnson's playing on Watson's, Tom, they'll be playing keepings off.
That's a nice pass.
They'll be playing on each other's bodies.
Cramery, 70 metres out, sends it long down towards full forward. Hurley is in this. Packing from the side, Goddard.
He came off ball then, Goddard. He ran from about the 50-metre arc on the other side of the ground, uncontested the whole way in and floated in, which we saw him do in the 2010 Grand Final. Very similar pattern in towards the ball. Takes it at the highest point. Great mark.
Never forget that jump, Nick, that 10 metres out mark he took in that 2010 Grand Final. Unbelievable.
There he is then, 20 metres out, and a different jumper, and he kicks the goal. Scores a level.
Really important for the Bombers to respond to the early goal. Here's the build-up when Jobe uses the ball exceptionally well. That's a great hit up there. And Cranberry is that sort of player he's going to present and present all day, launch himself at the contest, win in the contested situation. But Goddard, he's got to be watched pretty closely when he drifts forward like that.
Well, he's a big midfielder, isn't he? And that's the point. And he can mark above his head. So if he gets a run at a pack, he can jump on the pack. He didn't jump on the pack, then took the chest mark, but knows what he's doing in the air.
He kicked the opening goal of the match against the Saints, which would have pleased him greatly. And he gets the first goal tonight for the Bombers. Both these teams have been notoriously slow starters this season. For all the success they've had, they haven't been doing the job in the first term. It's been really third and fourth quarters, particularly where the Bombers are concerned in that fourth. So Kelly again out of the centre, tries to set it up for Johnson. Got an awkward bounce, went through his legs, and then Hocking on the up. So Haraka, slow. Taylor Hunt running him down, and well done. Little give was terrific. Gets it back to centre-half forward, and then Thurlow, first look at him, gets the ball right into that hot spot. Carlisle in trouble, doesn't get it away effectively. Hawkins, Myers was very good. Watson, well done. Handball, a little bit loose, though. On the up, Thurlow, well done to Hunt. Back to Hunt, getting it from Johnson. Thurlow looks a little bit like Stevie J at times. Early doors, Hawkins not quite over the line.
Hands in the back.
And a push in the back, hands in the back.
And just see with Carlisle's positioning, for a young player, he's not afraid to stand in front and take the space away from the key forward, which is it's a great trait to have so early in your career, Tom.
Ebbett, half back then, about 3 miles. Dashing player normally, and a dashing kick though, although bounces okay. Melcham feeds it forward, Gumbleton knocks it on, tracks it towards the boundary, and Thurlow takes it across the boundary. So, 6 wins apiece, 6 apiece in the early going at Etihad Stadium on a Friday night. West has been impressive. Very adroit at getting it behind himself. Not that time though. Bell Chambers won it. Watson getting a free kick, pushed in the back.
Oh, Stevie, stay there.
He's come through the contest hard. I mean, that's just the marking contest that Hibbert got over to spoil. So,
no confusion about that one. That's certainly a free kick, hands in the back. And the push also.
Hurley goes along the boundary, but the ball is coming back.
Throw it.
So.
Oh, no, guys, keep your meter mark at the back.
The umpy. Almost up to half forward. Bell Chambers comfortably over the back. Watson getting a lot of the ball early. Just couldn't get an effective handball away. Well done there by Bartell to Motlop, slung off it, and a boundary throw in.
The pressure's hot. Anyone who wants to win the footy tonight's going to have an opponent about to tackle him, and can they maintain the intensity? That's always a challenge, isn't it, physically?
So Blitzar's front spot, Howlett read it best. Howlett about 90 metres from goal, sets it up. Gumbleton front spot, gee, had a lot of it. He's a little bit stiff, maybe, and then Taylor puts the tackle on. It was interesting there, Mackie versus Gumbleton.
Real lost opportunity there for the Essendon Footy Club. You can see that the other forwards are trying to get that one-on-one with Gumbleton and Mackie. Potential advantage.
So Bell Chambers hooks it back. Kelly's been good early, can't get the kick away. Commas little give. Zaharakis, high ball to full forward. Held on too slightly. The Goddard take the mark, or rather Winderlich.
Well, I don't think he did, Bruce. I thought it came out.
He marked that. Thank you. Back on.
It's the classic case. You can hold your opponent out. Jimmy, you can't push. That's the controversy in the marking contest. But he held his ground with that stiff arm.
Good kick. Hits the post. Kicked a couple of very important set shots on Anzac Day. Back in the team.
Key to this game is going to be those sort of contests. If the Bombers can match the more physical Cats, so more physically developed Cats in the one-on-one situations.
Bartell down the middle. Hibbert, big leap, thumps it away. Hurley came after the footy. Kelly's been industrious so far. Duncan missed the target. Guthrie floating through. Myers grabs the footy. Hurried kick. Enright has to wait.
Push out, Palm.
Enright swings it wide. Now an opportunity as they build around the outer side. Motlop feeds it forward. Selwood back to Motlop. Runs beyond the wing. Probing kick inside the forward 50. Hall and Smith going back with a flag of it. Almost the clever mark. Spills across towards Stokes. Slips a hand pass away to Hawkins. And he's missed the dartboard. It's gone out on the full.
Mark's up here. Christensen, no. Mark's
just
here.
Just couldn't get the hook, Mark's big here. Tom.
It's Goddard's kick.
You notice the Geelong style early. They're happy to flick it around with a lot of handballs, which I think means occasionally they're going to turn it over, but occasionally they're going to come through really free of pressure like they did on that occasion.
And, Nick, that's generic, isn't it? With them, I mean, they handball the ball a lot, don't they? I mean, kick-to-handball ratio, the Bombers are much more a kicking team.
And that's the way they've played for a number of years now, Geelong.
It's worked OK, I would have thought, wouldn't you?
Yeah, it's been pretty successful.
So, Howlett.
Play on.
What a fine player he's become. Comer, they must like him. I mean, he's come from nowhere really a year ago. They tried him out pre-season. He got onto their list, and he's in their best 22 right now. Howlett gets it from Myers. Good-looking kick. Cranberry on the up. Hardingham looks up. Lovely kick to Davey. Now, this might stretch him, though. This might be a metre or two outside his range.
The forward set up for the Bombers at the moment with Cranberry playing up and Gumbleton deep is really stretching Geelong on that third tall defender. On that occasion, it was
here's the mark.
Guthrie, I think, trailing up on Cranberry, which is a really tough physical matchup.
13 goals this year, 5-2 from the set shots. He's such a creative player. He's right on 50. He struck it okay, but always to the near side. Got the distance, but not that accuracy.
Got four goals last week, Alan. Have to reconsider, Bruce. He's dangerous when he does have the foot.
He certainly is this year, and maybe a bit of last as well.
Martel, good kick. Duncan, fine player, takes the mark. Sends it down towards half forward. Half volleyed nicely by Stokes. Holds up a teammate, Thurlow, who's made a very impressive start. The kick comes down towards half forward. Hacked out of there by Bagley. It goes across the boundary line on the fall.
Blitzarth's also pushed forward. He pushed right from half back and has taken Bell Chambers with him. Bell Chambers could play this and just plonk himself for the long kick. Blitzarth will have to get him out of there.
Thurlow on debut, already four possessions. There's Martlaw having a wonderful season. Short one, but it's coming back. Bombers lead it by two and they're playing the better at the moment. Come on, guys.
Having a lot of trouble getting him on his line. I think we always put that under the umbrella of being just a bit pedantic because, I mean, he's kicking out six inches off his line. I remember, I guess.
This time last week, umpire Stavick was mic'd. We could have asked him what the heck's going on over there. Matt, there's Guthrie. He was OK last week too. Forward of the wing just jabs it inside the forward 50. Plenty of Bombers around the football. Loose at the back, Zaha Rakers. Hand pass nicely. Hocking to Howlett. Fisted back inside the 50. Watson's got it now, though. Measures the options. Goes back to the veteran.
Fletcher's kick. Asks a lot of Davey, and Taylor just belts the ball over the line. So it's a little win, I reckon, for Essendon.
Amazing. Nicky tries to mark the ball against the big guys, and he spoils against the little fellas.
I don't think he knew it was Davey, did you?
You could have put your house that he was going to swallow that one up.
So West Bell Chambers. Essendon's way. Comer to Heppel. Could he get some space? He's brought down. Enright is a good tackler. Came from Selwood. Enright's kick is a good one to Stokes. What a fine player. What a fine season. I mean, he's averaging over 28. Take the sub out. When he subbed that day, he's over 28 disposals this season.
Stay there.
Another emerging player in Motlop, and then Short, and gets Hawkins. So he's able to get away from Carlisle.
That all happened, wasn't it? It was Tate Pears was the spare defender, but his opponent was upfield. Yep, I think it was Critchardson, and he just basically allowed, he was just, not trying to mark the boot, allowed the Eston player to run past him, just missed who it was.
And
for a sec.
You'd think that's the area where Hawkins is going to have control. He's a much bigger body, much stronger. Carlisle's very athletic, but if he's in a position where he can push and then go, Hawkins will be favoured every time.
Well, he's been so accurate from set shots this year, Hawkins, and that one he's just pushed.
All clear, Adam.
So he misses.
Not Pears, that's Myers I was talking about, who didn't come back with to cover the extra blood.
So a couple of shots on goal for Hawkins. One he completely missed, and that one pushed it away.
Hardingham kicks it directly to Bartel. Bartel plays on immediately. Thurlow, love his game so far. On the lead, Smets is about 55 metres out and in trouble. Well, what a problem. Coughed it up. Zaharakis to Heppel. Bartel with the head down might get a free kick. Bartel inside the centre square. So a chance to regroup for the Cats.
Plays a lot of footy across half-back now, Jimmy Bartel, informing that line across the middle of the ground.
Blitzarves in front and lurking behind. Stokes has taken the mark about 35 metres out. So off and the way. Kicks a 3D sometimes. Well, just about every time.
Jimmy.
And some players see it in 1v.
That was that free kick was played by the umpire 50 metres away. I reckon the umpire who saw that probably adjudicated. In fact, there wasn't any high contact on Bartel.
Stokes was the man who judged the depth of that kick. Here he is, 40 metres out then. Kick is on the way and does what Hawkins failed to do. He puts it through.
And Dennis, you've commented a number of times about Jackson Thurlow wearing the number of triple premiership player David Wojcinski. Really strong raps on him as a sort of Joel Corey, Corey Enright clone, the young Taswegian.
First round draft pick for the Cats last year, Thurlow. So he was taken at 16 and the next was 77 and then after that it was a 90-odd, so he was clearly their choice.
We came here with big expectations. After 15 minutes, this is two good teams in form. Great pressure, great game.
What you expected, Lou?
Yeah, what you hoped for. Yeah.
Heppel held up. West does well. Searwood, well done by Comer. Got down low and then maybe unluckily didn't get one from... He does now.
Around his neck.
It did look that the first contact. So Nick Comer to Watson. And then Watson out wide. Melsham. He's only missed one game in about the last 50-odd Melsham, and that was a couple of weeks ago. Goes short. Zaharakis, such an intelligent, dynamic player. Gee, that's a good mark, isn't it? At full stretch from Cranmery.
Okay,
so often looks like he's going to run under the footy, but then at the last minute he's got that leap from the front spot and the high extension of the arms above his head. He marks so often like that.
Now, he's 10 goals too from set shots. This is a very difficult kick. Tight angle, long, long way out. I mean, this would be something if he could go the distance and have the accuracy at the same time. And he sets it up about 5 metres out, couple of big flies, one coming from Bill Chambers in the behind. The black armbands, by the way, for the Bombers tonight, Bob Tobias, a trainer, passed away. He was with the team for 20 years, including the 93 and 2000 premierships. So in honour of Bob Tobias tonight for the Bombers.
Bartel, short to the pocket.
Dennis, just quickly an update on Taylor Hunt. He's headed down to the Geelong Rooms. He's done his right shoulder. The docs are checking him out. He's been off the ground for about 10 minutes now. Oh. He ran into Jake Melksham, so we'll keep an eye on whether or not a sub's made.
Yeah, bad news there. Very important to them. There's Goddard sending it back inside the 50. Courageous mark. Terrific mark. Zaharakis. Bartel coming hard. Zaharakis knew somebody was.
He's a better player than a lot of people give him credit for, David Zaharakis. He's right at the top of his game. And just see Taylor Hunt there. That's a potential massive blow. He's got the run with job with Joe Watson, but maybe a David Zaharakis in the future.
Yeah. Fairest and best two seasons ago. Wasn't a stellar season for the Bombers, but gee, he came on an early season injury this year. And he takes this kick to the left. Late starter, but... We've got warm on Anzac Day.
So Essendon, just one goal from four set shots so far tonight. They haven't been easy, but they're missing them.
Move it on. Fire on.
Motlop to Guthrie.
Oh, Nick.
Such an inexperienced team, this Geelong team. It's quite amazing. Here's Kelly. He's not one of the inexperienced. He's one of those triple premiership players out there. We've got a couple of triple premiership players that are not playing tonight in Corey and Chapman, and a dual premiership player in Josh Hunt. So three guys that would probably come in at some stage, certainly over the next month. Guthrie. And then Horland Smith short. And now Johnson, so creative through the mid, and then squeezes the ball.
High tackle.
But not a good result. It's Hocking.
Stop Hocking. Back of the head.
Gee, what a difference Hocking made last week when he came out as a sub.
That extra strong body in the middle, it just complements their group.
Fletcher took a while, eventually to Heppel. Heppel goes wide to Zaharakis again. He's about 60 metres out. Only one Essendon player inside the forward 50. Now a couple. As Gumbleton floods back, this is Hibbert. He's got the ball about 70 metres out to Fletcher.
Geelong now with every player set up behind the ball, so you'd imagine Essendon will be quite happy to just chip it around and wait until they can find an opening and penetrate inside 50.
Nottingham, who got it from Bagley, kicks it down towards half forward, taken by Hooker. So Hooker, about 75 metres out, wants some movement. Bell Chambers is offering, sends the ball in that direction. West has a run. Will he get there in time? Split the pack. Taken by Myers. He snaps towards goal. Hangs it out to the left, behind.
He's been good, Myers. I mean, it took a long, long time. He's a high draft pick. He took four or five seasons really to establish himself. Few injuries, but he's found his spot. Big-bodied midfielder, Mackey. Back to Guthrie, back to Hall and Smith. Danger, clever, well played to Smith. Now they open it up. Motlop away. One bounce, two. Johnson wanting to get involved. Motlop uncertain now. Has a little stimmy and stammy, and then loads it up and says, "I'll do it myself." And he didn't quite. Well, I reckon Stevie J missed him up.
Yeah, I think Stevie J had to tell him to keep coming. I mean, he wanted to receive the footy when really he was in control of being able to create the path for Modlock to really just break the 50-metre line easily.
Oh, yes, but there's no accounting for genius. Just ran off the rails there, Stevie J. Took his man to the ball carrier. And Modlock didn't expect that. Bill Chambers has got the footy now. Short one. Kelly almost, but Howlett. Fifth in the best and fairest last season. Centering ball to Carlisle, who flirts with the idea of going. Doesn't. Goes across the ground. Hooker's got it now. On the move on the wing is Hurley. Ignores that. Goes deeper. Melksham. Melksham is about 75 metres out. Lays it off. Winderlich has it now. Well, made to look okay by Myers. That was going to be chopped off. It was a poor kick. But Myers got across and, as I say, made it look terrific.
This has probably been the most impressive. We just see the injury to Taylor Hunt here where he's hurt his shoulder. Just right on the point of contact it was, which is a nasty one. But the build-up from the Bombers, where they've really improved is their kicking efficiency. They're absolutely elite. Controlled the tempo of that play and Myers the end result.
Myers from 50 there. Gives it a ride. He's a strong kick and that's no exception. Bombers back in front.
Coffee can be fun. With the new Nescafe Dolce Gusto machine and its selection wheel, making coffee has never been so entertaining. Nescafe Dolce Gusto. Coffee is not just...
Shh, don't tell your friends.
Well, a lot of coaches now spend time down on the bench, but it's a rarity for Chris Scott. You can see him talking there with Stevie Johnson. He really needs that middle part of the ground fixed up. Joe Watson's had the six touches, Zaharakis nine. Essendon moving the ball far too easy.
And right on cue there, Lingy, because Watson out of the centre. Saw Myers a moment ago. He averaged nine games in his first five season, Myers. He really struggled to get a foothold in this team, but that was a great kick from a brilliant mark.
Talk about the value of Heath Hocking for the Bombers, Bruce. Selwood just a one touch so far this game.
And of course, the Cats have lost their run with player, haven't they, in Taylor Hunt. So, good omen there for Essendon. Watson, Howlett, gets it to Bell Chambers off a step to 4-4. Gumbledon in a good spot. Flying Winderlich, good tackle on Thurlow. Davey, Hurley hooks, doesn't quite get enough on it.
Gee, they look dangerous down there, the Bombers. Yeah. They look undersized, Geelong.
Gumbledon's the one, is he? You feel like he's got a height advantage. Every time the ball comes in high, it hasn't quite stuck for him yet.
When you've got three, they're a genuine three turn idea. We'll get back to that point.
Keeler's kick. Ebert goes after it. Hall and Smith on one knee. Foxed it out. Podsy Adley. Haven't called his name too often. Kicks it up towards the wing. Bombers lead in all directions to the footy. Carlisle takes the mark. Plays on. Comes to Zaharakis, who's been a live wire. On the move is Winderlich. Winderlich is marked just forward of the interchange gates. Again, Comer offers. They're putting themselves about up ahead of the ball, the Bombers. They're anxious to get it, and that's a good sign. Winderlich takes something off this kick, just setting it up. Hurley comes at the pack. Gumbledon up in front, spills behind, and taken across the line by Guthrie. Lost his compass. But the umpire says, well, it happens to a lot of people. It'll be tossed in.
The point before was Essendon do have three really key, strong marking targets. And not many clubs have the three defenders to man up on that. That's a challenge for the Cats.
Good tackle on Comer. And then off the ground by West. Duncan has to wait and ride the tide that came at him. He knew they were at a ball up.
They haven't taken their shots, Essendon, obviously 2-5, but they've taken half a dozen inside 50 marks. The last 3 weeks, Geelong are averaging about 9 or 10 against in a whole game. So they've started well.
Goddard can't quite get that handball away. Zarakis gets a bit on that, gets to centre half forward. Big flight in the back from Hall and Smith. Zarakis waited, good hands to Bill Chambers, to Fletcher off a step. Was it touched on the way through or was it out on the fall? It's out on the fall. So Fletcher, as we talked about at the start of the match, 38 during the week, only the third player in the last 85 years. The other, Tuck and Bradley, to have played at that age. It's a remarkable effort.
Zaharak is up to 12 possessions, and now we've got an infringement.
Played on over the boundary line, so it's out of bounds.
I was looking up ahead.
He came in, then went back over the line.
A big explanation by Stevic. Just under 3 minutes till quarter time. Taylor Hunt, that's bad news. Sung his praises before the game. Podsy Adley taps it down. Guthrie scuffs a kick. 13 possessions now for Zaharakis. Selwood knew that and wanted to see how fast he could rack them up limping. Ball goes out of bounds. We'll have a boundary throw in.
Dennis, you just mentioned Taylor Hunt putting the ice on the shoulder. He's done for the night. He's got the red vest. Young Jordan Schroeder's just taking the green vest on. He'll join the game shortly.
Okay. So a couple of rookies in the action now for the Cats. Harry looking for a free kick. Blitzabs tries to get it out. Commas over the football. Christensen, tackled by Windelick. Ball jarred out of there. Johnson goes back to Bartell. Deep in his own defensive area. Measured the kick to Duncan. Now they're away. Mackey through midfield. Long telling kick to the outer side. This will be interesting. Bagley should be nervous. Motlop's got the football. He's up on his toes. Bagley comes to him now. Cat and mouse. Hand pass comes. That was an anti-climax. Get it across towards Thurlow. Kicks it down towards the pocket. And the ball runs out of bounds. We'll have a throw in.
You know, sides are playing good football when they do the real basics well. And manning the mark is something that probably doesn't get lauded all that often.
Do you just feel like Geelong have played themselves on into trouble a few times?
A couple of times.
A few opportunities going forward.
Yep.
West lays it down to Haaland Smith. Saw Schroeder a moment ago. Yep. Haaland Smith's handball. Back to Bagley. He played that a moment ago very cleverly, didn't he? And then got out to Comer. I mean, Geelong really looked on, didn't they, when Motlop took that mark?
Well, Motlop is the one. He messed that up a little bit, but he's the one who really looks the most dangerous for Geelong centre forward.
Taylor belts it away. Comer getting a bit of the ball early, takes his man on, gets around Enright. Powlett, Comer, still with Comer, showing a bit of poise and then hooking the ball back. Cramery and Lonigan, and that was pretty easy for the defender, belted the ball over the line. So at the moment, nothing in the scoreboard, but you feel like Essendon, I mean, certainly the Taylor Hunt's a massive blow. I mean, did Geelong have a run with player now for the rest of the night, or do they just go orthodox? Certainly Hocking will be running with Selwood, who copped the high one. Johnson going backwards for a moment, thinking, bouncing, handballing, creating. Christensen, Taylor, sweeping. Now Mackey's a good kick, but he can't get away from Davey. He's just as dangerous without it, Dennis.
I think you're right, Bruce. Purple intended for Zaharakis, knocked away by Selwood, and the ball spills out of bounds. We'll have a boundary throw, and the Bombers lead it by three.
He might have only had the two possessions so far, Joel Selwood, but his ability to crash a body, create a contest, is second to none in the competition.
Brings an attitude, doesn't he?
Four tackles leading all comers in that category.
Throwing out aside, Gumbleton. He'll ruck well if he's left alone like that. Got it down to Watson, Melksham, Goddard feeds it back. Hibbert with a natural right footer, but that's okay. Comes to Carlisle, the clock to 44 seconds. Carlisle has the bounce, looks back inside the centre square, leads his runner to the football, and Melksham couldn't take his eyes off the footy. Is marked down towards half forward. Johnson picks up the mark to space on the lead. Windelick getting a fist in there. Guthrie. Opportunity for Enright. Windelick again. Guthrie came again. Knocked the ball across towards Christensen. Christensen runs away. Kicks it out towards the wing. And this ball will trickle out of bounds. And the clock will stop at 16 seconds.
Great spoil, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just to get there, get the fist, no pressure on the body, just fist to the footy.
Bill Chambers takes it clearly against West and then belting the ball forward. Hurley coming in hard on Thurlow's made a big impression. So the big news of the first quarter, Taylor Hunt gone for the night with a shoulder. Schroeder gets a run.
Nice work, step right, come!
No surprise, Lovett Murray, the sub for the Bombers. So Geelong free kick.
Hold there.
Zaharakis, 13 disposals in the opening term. And what a great first quarter. Just what we wanted, expected here. Sell out Friday night footy. And it's Essendon leading Geelong. It's 17-14.
Time break brought to you by Amy.
Show you, there's Taylor Hunt on screen now. Lingy, what can you tell us about the injury?
Well, he's clearly done his shoulder. We can see it icing up. We don't know how bad yet, Tim, but he's been subbed out of the game, as you can see by the red vest there. Jordan Schroeder's the man, and you can see the incident there just straight away. Knew something was wrong. The docs checked him out down in the rooms, but no good at all. Couldn't come back on, out in the ground, and has been subbed off, unfortunately.
How will that affect their balance tonight?
Oh, huge impact. David Zaharakis, as Dennis has mentioned, has been absolutely dominating tonight's game. 13 possessions. He was the man who initially went to David Zaharakis, and Zaharakis is running amok. You see on the flip side, Heath Hocking playing a role on Joel Selwood. Joel's only had the two touches, so a huge impact on the game tonight.
On these really tight, aggressive games, close games, you've really got to impose your will upon the game. I just want to show you some vision. This is David Myers in the first quarter. The kick is from Winderlich. Now, this is going to the Cats. They're going to force a turnover here. Terrific play there by Myers. I mean, so courageous to be able to do that. And that's exactly what you need to be able to do. Cut a kickoff like that, but just impose your courage on the game itself. And that was just outstanding play. Goes back and kicks a goal in a very tight game.
And you've got to take those opportunities in the tight games. It might only pop up every now and then. Huge game. Take your chances.
I have to say, Tommy, you're very good at reading the Geelong tea leaves. What are you reading at the present time?
I think we just saw the stats there, the contested possession. That'd be the one you'd be driving home. I guess when you've been a side that's been dominant for a long period of time, you're coming up against a side that's challenging the mantle. That's the area of the game you want to win, and Chris Scott would have driven that home nice and fast. I think the loss of Taylor Hunt's a big one. Maybe George Hall and Smith, who was a rising star as a defensive player against the Swans, could be the perhaps the next in line to play a defensive run with
one of the rare games where the hit-outs are mooing the clearances. Bell Chambers is doing a terrific job in the air, and then the ground level Essendon getting it as well.
17 players, 14.
Oh, Essendon, hold of the arm.
Straight away. So Bell Chambers gets the free after the opening bounce to the second term. Gives it off. Hibbert pushing up. Kicks down towards half-forward Cramery. Do they look dangerous on the forward line? So much movement. Cramery. Take something off the kick. It's ill-directed, though. On a different page to the man he had intended to be on the end of it. Mackie goes short. Bartel. Defensive 50. Bartel. Nice kick. Podsy Adley eases into the marking contest. No contest, really. Wheels around and deals inside the forward 50. Hawkins goes back. Hasn't kicked many goals against the Bombers, but he's got one here. I think it was 8 from 5 games. But that's a beauty.
It's interesting here to have a look at what he does. He pushes off, comes back.
So have you taken the mark, Lee? Was it a mark or not? Or was it a free kick against him?
Well, he certainly used his body to make sure the Esther Carlisle couldn't get back into the contest. He certainly bumped and blocked a little.
So Goddard, back to Watson, back to Goddard. Kicks to centre-half forward. Lee doesn't normally sit on the fence, but I reckon that's a fencer. Here's Hurley. Goes back to Myers. There's a left footer and a long left footer and a good one. How about that?
Oh, that's fantastic. Yeah, that was a fantastic goal by Myers. I mean, getting a couple of goals and pushing forward, that sort of is a bonus. So at the moment, Hurley and Gumbleton aren't marking the ball in the air. Cranwey's looking dangerous. But there's Myers sniffing in for a couple.
Well, he's only kicked one goal this season, so two tonight. Good stuff by Hurley to get it to him, though.
And the intention from Goddard to hit the ball long straight away. I genuinely get the sense that the Essendon forwards feel like they've got an advantage deep forward. Did rebound out and came back in, but you've got some pretty potent forwards up there, the Bombers.
And the clearances then, they become that important for Geelong. If Essendon feel like they have that advantage, well, the best way for Geelong to take it away, win the clearances and get it going forward.
David Myers has got a couple of goals now. Pick 6 in the 2007 draft from the Perth Footy Club. And they've been patient with him, the Bombers. Comes across from Johnson to Selwood. Smothered off the boot. Christensen grabs it, though. Little chip pass down towards right half forward. This is Schroeder. Kicks long down towards full forward. Hawkins puts the body in, move the pack. Loose ball at the back, well played by Fletcher. Deflected it to Hooker. Hooker gives it to Watson. Watson, so cool. Bell Chambers sends it out towards the wing. In front out there was Cramery. Loose ball. Oh, clever Zaharakis. Gave it to Hocking. Now Heppel's away. Gumbleton's drifting to space. Gumbleton's taken the mark 40 metres out.
What a clever kick. Just that ability to have the vision first and foremost to look outside your channel and use your outside of your foot to deliver the ball inside forward 50. Get a good look at it here. Just watch his eyes. Knows where he wants to go. Last minute. Out.
15 guard.
Copy book. Scott Gumbleton. Kicks from right on the 50. Another West Australian puts it through, and suddenly Geelong have got problems.
Tim, it's been a torture journey for Gumbleton so far. This is a massive night for him.
Absolutely. This is the biggest game he's played in a long, long time. Probably the biggest game of his career. And they've shown a lot of faith in him, too, in keeping him in the side and not going with Paddy Ryder to know. And he'd be well aware of that.
So he makes the most of that opportunity. But in the back there, so Selwood just starting to get his hands on the ball. Remember in Sydney, halfway through the second quarter, where he just wheeled Geelong and turned a match around. Hawkins, big fly, couldn't get near it. Podziadli, just a fumble. Well done, though, and Motlop gets up behind. That was a soda, wasn't it?
Looks so dangerous with ball in hands. I mean, he fluffed the chance, kicked inaccurately, but he's just his pace to actually give himself that yard or two to balance.
So he's missed a couple of running shots tonight. That one a lot easier than the first one in the opening term.
Fletcher, short. Goddard. The opening goal tonight. Told to play on. Ambles away, kicks it outside the defensive 50. Poor kick, though. They want to play this guy back into the game. Selwood, it was kicked directly to him. Goes short, finds Enright. Enright forward of the wing. Kicked a beautiful goal last week in a milestone game. Goes short to Mackey. Mackey finds himself inside the centre square. Unloads long. They come from all directions. Hibbert. Eyes only for the footy. Bodies clattering to the ground behind him. Steadfastly held his ground, floated in, took the mark. Comes to Bill Chambers. Bill Chambers still inside the defensive 50. Early going second term. The two undefeateds going at it. Essendon so far doing slightly the better. Johnson in from the side. Great mark. Acrobatic. Just controlled his body like a master puppeteer.
And then switches, as he often does, to Mackey. So one triple premiership player to another, to Taylor. And then Taylor just loads it up, sets it to about 10 metres. Hawkins shoves and shoves. And a strong mark by Bill Chambers in 50.
Really interesting the way Tom Hawkins has decided to play this matchup with Carlo. He's quite happy to start from behind and try and work Carlo under the ball. The trouble is, if he doesn't do that, the Essendon players are able to float across the side and take it the easy mark, as we saw then.
So that was touched off the boot now. Melsham did well, actually, got through and then created space, and Davies on his own. And he'll run on, and the Bombers get a break. They kick away.
Most impressive part about Essendon this year has just been their setups around the ground. Bill Chambers knowing what his role is as the ruckman to fill a hole. We spoke about Hibbert also, ability to read the cues and then just spread so aggressively, offensively.
So the margin out to 14 points now. Bill Chambers on the way down to Heppel. Heppel sends it once again inside the forward 50. Mackey flew from behind. Davey onto the loose ball, 70 metres out. Sold Melchin into trouble. And he's bundled across the boundary line by the first gamer. That's Thurlow. Six possessions in the first term, the boy from Launceston. Fit right in. West having his problems with Bell Chambers. Neither ruckman touched at that time. Heppel courageously into the pack. Kelly into the path of Motlop like a basketballer. Almost dribbled it through the pack. Christensen gives a hand pass away. Blitzarves. Now it's Schroeder. Runs inside the centre square, sweeping hand pass, bounced okay. Christensen back into the path of Holland Smith, under pressure, snaps and misses out to the right. They did well, pressure the whole way, but they controlled the footy.
She commented well then, Dennis, right at the end as he's chased down. that just gave Hall and Smith a nervous moment. The kick to centre wing. So against Winderlick to Guthrie. So short. Christensen. What a great article Peter Hanlon wrote about Christensen this morning and his father and mother and just the sacrifices and the journey they've made. Not a great kick. Zaharakis. Winderlick, strange handball. Back to Christensen. Hocking. Kelly. Inside. Johnson. Clever. Bartel on the burst. Now he may go for goal here, Jimmy. Kicks to full forward. Carlisle work to the front. Whoa. Bouncing ball. Is it a goal to Smits? No. It's a behind.
A dangerous goal line spoil. They tried to force the ball through from behind both the Eston Tor defenders, but they almost sort of got in each other's way and the ball fell into the goal square.
Toughest ball to try and execute that when you're going with the flight of the ball. It's just fraught with danger that you'll mistime it. Rarely do you get enough purchase on it to deliver it. Always best to knock it wide.
Fletcher to Carlisle. He's in the back pocket. Call the play on. Kicks under pressure. High ball. Well short of the wing. Bell Chambers up. So is Gumbleton. Not necessarily good policy there. Schroeder applies a tackle. Hocking found the loose ball to Zaharakis. Overlapping Melchum goes right across the ground. Real chance here for the Cats, but Guthrie missed the footy. Chance for Winderlick at the back. Under pressure, no one to give off to. Held it a long time. Goes to Hooker. Nonchalantly does exactly that up towards the wing. Leading back is Watson. My money's on Watson. Silly tracks for football. Melchum hand passes to Winderlick. There's a wave of bombers across the ground. And this man can kick a long way. There goes Hibbert's kick. And it's home. He puts it through. Wonderful stuff from the Bombers. End-to-end stuff at Etihad Stadium.
He can kick the ball. He's running off half-back. Myers started in defence. He's kicked a couple of goals, and Hibbert's just pushed up with the flow of the ball, but they've got so much run when they carry the ball through the middle of the ground.
And Tom, what about Watson's effort at centre wing? I mean, Dennis said, my money's on Watson. That was huge.
Massive. I mean, it's a really important time for the Bombers now to really put a brake on the Cats, because we know that the Cats can kick multiple goals in a hurry.
Watson to Melsham. Gumbleton got underneath it. Davey is so quick. Mackie knew it. And Mackie's not slow, but Davey gave him a metre and got in front of him. Watson's imposing himself here. Dennis made the point, no Brownlow medal votes against the Cats.
Geelong have somehow been good, being well down in the clearances, but Essendon are just taking the ball away and then just too quick when they get out in space at the moment.
Mackie sends it outside the defensive 50, off hands at the back. Bagley goes back to Fletcher. Fletcher spots a man up ahead. Hurley, 55 metres out, Hurley. The Bombers looking the better team. 52 metres out now as he kicks. Sharp angle. Gumbleton waits. Tailor-made for Lonigan. Just ghosting in. Gets a fist on it. Puts it through.
What we're seeing with the Bombers at the moment is a playing group that genuinely has belief in the style of football that they've been taught over a period of time now. And you're getting players like Hibbert. You're getting players like Myers. Who's starting just to grow and grow and grow in confidence. And really enjoying the big stage tonight.
Not long.
Hold there, Mark.
Well, they're playing with a chip on their shoulder, aren't they? It is them against the world in many respects. Motlop. Johnson tracks it towards the boundary. Bit of a fumble. Still Johnson. Selwood. No, it's not Selwood. It's fed back out. It's taken by Motlop. Motlop running across half back. It was Thurlow. Motlop's kick, though, under the chest of Howlett.
Talking about that belief in your structures, you know you're on song when you're taking the ball off the opposition in your front half of the ground like that.
They tried to create, didn't they, Geelong? But when you kick it from deep in the goal square back in the centre corner, it would turn it over.
And that's the way they play. You live and die by the sword. It's been so successful for them. And when they get through, they're able to score so easily. So you've got to wear some of these if you play the way they do.
Ben Howlett, terrific season last year. Unfashionable player. Could it be another Perth boy to kick a goal here? Close to the man on the mark. Kicker's on the way. Swinging left, misses.
When I said you've got to wear them, I'm not sure Chris Scott would be all that happy about
this
wearing
point
them.
But... And Rui, you still got to weigh up, I think, the take a calculated risk. That one there by Motlop was just going for too much. You've got to be smarter about that, see the option better, and be a bit smart with the risks you take.
Try to torpedo punch. He's a good mark by Stokes. That was... Bartel and then Stokes quickly on to Podziadli, who plays up on the wing a lot certainly this season. And then Podziati, that's a great-looking kick to Blitzarves. Well done, though, getting back Cramry. Watson couldn't quite get a handle on it. And Duncan, normally a good kick. And Geelong get the one they needed.
Well, three behinds in 3 minutes. Answered with that goal from Duncan. Grew up barracking for the Bombers. His footy hero was James Hurd. Hurdy right there. Watson slaps it forward. Follows up his own earlier work. Kicks inside the forward 50. Hand pass from Podsy Adley. Did okay. Stokes with time. Measures the kick. Comes to Taylor. Could he go forward soon? Johnson. Terrible effort. Kicks inside the forward 50. West went down to find it. Couldn't. Hand pass to Hardingham from Hooker. Goes all the way back now to Fletcher. Fletcher. But pedestrian Fletcher, that's okay though. Man of his advancing years. Goddard goes back to Hardingham. Hardingham, hard against the boundary line. Swings it wide. Bill Chambers in front. And young Furlough again just plucks it. Gives it away to Kelly. This is easy stuff for the young man from Launceston. Goes short, finds Taylor. He'll wheel around on his left foot. Hocking was lax on the mark. Kick goes down towards full forward. Launching from behind is Hawkins. Well off, hands it across the line.
They've made the move to Long. They've identified their short down back and their undersize. And James Podziadli is actually playing at centre-half back on Cramery.
So just Bruce, keep an eye on Harry Taylor potentially drifting forward also, but still playing across half-back.
Fletcher picked the wrong man with Blitzarves a moment ago, didn't he, when he tried to get around him. So Carlo hacking forward to Comer. Well done by Comer. Myers has been so good. And then with a penetrating kick now, Davey will be the danger here. Watch for him. Enright. Well, did it well, Enright. He still might be a danger, Davey. Lonigan on the up. The bounce important. Podziadli did well. He hacked it forward. Stokes, another important mark. Now, Horlicks miss off the boundary here, off the interchange. And they're away, the Cats. Don't you go on Australian on me, Dennis. Horlicks
is that Australian, Bruce?
Up forward. Hawkins, bouncing ball, Blitzarves and Fletcher, Carlisle and Hawkins, well done Carlisle, off Hocking, Blitzarves over the top, Fletcher to mop up, only as far as Taylor.
That's 15 metres, gee.
Oh, dear.
So not 15, not wasn't touched, so Smits, brilliantly done, Hocking and missing the lock.
Every now and again, doesn't he, Fletcher, he just gets rid of the ball out of the back 50 and...
So it was a touch off
the boot.
Gee.
Inconclusive, I think, that footage might have been.
But the umpire certainly caught it touch, did he? It was certainly, it went more than 20 metres or more than the 15.
Goddard in the back pocket, goes right across the front of goal, finds Bagley, the margin 14 points. Midway through the term, Bagley, very short. That's barely 15. They've got the goal square alongside. You can measure that. Was about 3 metres in from the boundary. He marked about 2 metres beyond the end of the goal square. Never mind, Bagley's got it. Goes across towards Hardingham. That's a beautiful kick. Threaded it down the line. Hocking's got it. Hocking's been very valuable tonight so far. Sends a high ball. Target is Bell Chambers. Almost the mark. Podziadli knocked it away. Thurlow gives a hand pass to Kelly. Kelly a sweeper towards midfield, taken by Holland Smith to the run of Stokes. Stokes spots Selwood and finds him directly in front, 45 metres out. He'll kick from about 52. Well, this is a big kick.
That's it, Joel. Just there.
Margin at 40.
Right on his limit here, I think, Den.
Yes, but sometimes he does what he's not expected to do. Some players do what they can. Often this man does what he can't. Selwood, kick is on the way. Has it got the carry? I think it has. He's done it again. That's remarkable. Joel Selwood kicks the goal.
He's kicked a goal in every match this year, Selwood, yeah, which is something he doesn't normally do. I mean, that's a fantastic response now by Geelong in the last 5 minutes. They've kicked the last two. 21 points was the big margin. Went early west. Zarakis, 13 disposals in that opening turn. And a bit of a change here over the match. So again, Zarakis.
West.
So West wanting to give off. Mackey, Johnson, so involved, fending off. Back it goes to West. And then West gets a bit on it to fall forward. Hawkins out in number. Good mark in the front. taken by Hooker. Carlo was mining Hawkins. Hooker came in Heppel. Let's see how the Bombers respond late in the second term.
Heppel has to come to ground. Heppel sends it up towards the wing. Johnson again. Sends it inside the forward 50. Ill-directed, though. His kicking hasn't been good tonight, Steve Johnson. The mark is taken by Hooker.
He's always happy to go onto his left foot, Johnson, but I still think he makes a lot of errors or just doesn't make good contact left foot.
Hibbert to Carlisle, two emerging stars in defence for the Bombers. Myers, who's booted a couple of goals, just taking the sting out of the game right now.
Cats need to press right up here and cover all exit areas.
High ball, close to the boundary line, in right, got first hands to it. Podsy Adley lurking in front of the pack. Down towards the pocket, the mark is taken by Duncan. Looks towards the middle. Plenty to choose from. Decides on the first gamer. Anointed him and kicked the ball directly to Furlow.
And the man who got the entry there, James Podziadny, has had a big influence since he's gone back. He's had the six touches this quarter, but really set them up. A smart move. They were undersized down back, getting Podsy down there, and he's doing a great job.
Lonigan did well on the outer side as well. That searching hand pass out of the congestion, sending them away. Jackson Furlough, 45 metres out. Family came over from Tasmania today to watch the game. And he misses.
Good test for the Bombers now. We've all marvelled how well they've developed and had a six-zip start. They've got to continue to attack the game here. You can't afford to just put the cue in the rack. Be more assured coming out of the back line like they were early in the game.
So nothing gained there, Carlo. Back to Goddard. Hibbert now. Hibbert can break a line and kick a long ball, but he decides to slow it down and then comes wide with that long kick. Bill Chambers flew well. Well done by West. Kelly caught the high one. Heppel getting down low. Terrific tackle by Kelly, but it was a high. Free kick to Heppel.
Back. Guys clear out. Guys in Heppel.
So Heppel wasted the last ball he had here. He wants to go short. Well, Ben back to Carlisle. Not sure if this is working all that well. Now they may open up. Hibbert can go out to Hardingham. Now Hardingham, again Geelong able to hold them up for the moment. Hardingham into Myers. Now Myers, that long left footer. Can he get enough on it? Well, the kick's poor and Lonigan marks it. So Essendon, their disposal that we talked about, Tom, earlier being so efficient is letting them down.
Not looking as assured with the ball in hand coming out of the back line at the moment, Bruce. It's that, I guess, that mental maturity, the way they're going to improve.
Motlop, how is that? Found it on the deck. The ball hadn't bounced to about waist high, and he had it again. Paulin Smith squares it across the ground. Zaharakis has dried up in this term. Just the one possession. Taylor looking for the leading player. It was Stokes, got hands to it, couldn't take it. Coming through is Fletcher. He kicks it up towards the wing, and Cramery. They need a goal now, Essendon. They're absorbing a lot of pressure. Gumbleton, fingertips to it, spills behind. Furlough again. Podsy Adley, Kelly, been terrific. Johnson, thought about laying it off, almost back into the clutches of Hocking. Furlough, Podsy Adley.
Oh, there, Scott.
Will he go down the line or change things? He'll change things. He goes to the middle. Hall and Smith can take it and go. Short one is on. Stokes comes up, takes the mark. Suddenly it's Geelong who are running. Mackey takes off from behind the play. He could be involved now. Well, that was a shocking kick. Went directly to Hurley, who squares the ball. Zaharakis, I just mentioned him, only his second possession of the term.
Goes short to Goddard, to Hardingham. Now they create here. Can he get the ball to Davey? It's a terrible kick again. And they keep on missing targets, the Bombers.
I think it's the pressure at Geelong, though. They're really pushing up hard and not giving us a great leap, wasn't it, by not a lot, but really making the difficult targets, and Essendon are not able to handle that that pressure.
And in the first half of the quarter, Essendon, they were inclined to go really quickly once they created a turnover. They just seem to be holding themselves up at the moment. I think that's playing into Geelong's hands.
Zaharakis just hacked it out. Johnson. So still with Johnson. Well, he set Hall and Smith a task there, Johnson. Just sometimes he makes those decisions that are just too creative and complex. So Guthrie's free kick, so the Cats get out of it. Can they hit the front by half-time? You feel they're closing so quickly here.
Nine possessions for Stevie J in this term. Thurlow. Forward of the wing. High ball from behind. The big leap comes from Lonigan. Well, he's been defending stoutly on the outer side wing. They weren't getting enough up forward, so he's decided, well, I'll go down there and help them out.
It's spectacle, isn't it? One of their big defenders drifts into the forward line. Shows the forwards how to do it.
Well, he started, didn't he, Tommy, as a forward? He
kicked the first goal in 2008 Grand Final, and he was certainly drafted as a key forward and then moved back. Pretty much for a necessity for the team, really, and he's developed into a top-class defender, but he attacked the ball like a key forward then.
No doubting this man's courage. Testimony to courage. In he comes. Kick is on the way and it's good. There's a point for difference. Whoa, they've come back.
It's one of those really enjoyable run back to your, you see the inside 50s there. That certainly shows the momentum of the game. But Tom Lonigan got the glory run from full forward all the way back to full back.
He spread those fingers, Tom, didn't he? He came with those fingers spread as he took that mark. Almost broke his own webbing, I reckon. Kick comes down inside the forward 50. Charging out was Davey. Going to ground was Kelly. Christensen gets a hand pass. Zaharakis. Melksham. Bombers in front still. Almost forgotten in all of this. Oh, that's a good kick into the 50. And Davey with a chance to extend the lead so close to half-time.
Good centre bounce clearance win. I mean, when you get that centre bounce clearance, it gives it forwards the best opportunities to find a hole into the... I mean, it's like two good teams. It goes in ebbs and flows. Essendon have a good 10 minutes. Geelong then have a good 10 minutes. That's just what good teams do. Just keep at it.
This has been a remarkable story. He was there for forward pressure. Now he's there to do exactly... Well, no. We'll start again. He's there to kick goals.
One thing we see now is small forwards become targets in the forward 50 as well.
Yep.
And with the zoning that goes on often, they're the actual best target on, not necessarily the big fellas.
Guthrie and Johnson getting their own game going. Bartel goes back. Mark is taken by Enright. Skipping a jump, Enright to centre half back and Stokes. We're down to 40 seconds now.
Play on, yours.
And they're playing as if they know that, although that's a dangerous kick. They've done a couple of those. Eventually it comes across to Enright, to Johnson. Johnson runs through the centre square then, searching, kick, Ponziadley was up, couldn't hang on, flinging it out of the pack was Hawkins, knocked away by Hardingham, Hawkins grabs the football, trying to crash his way through as Cranmery, that's a throw, and it will be a free kick, and will go Geelong's way, and against all the odds, they've got a chance of leading at half-time, they trailed by 21 points midway through this term.
Great effort by Schroeder on the stronger man in Cranberry there, but what we saw was the difference between the mindset of the two defences. Yep. When Geelong had the ball, they were playing tempo, but they were moving the ball forward and gained some meterages.
Oh, Schroeder started as the sub.
Right on the mark.
Required to kick a goal after the siren. It's got everything. Schroeder comes in and he doesn't let his team down. He puts it through. Terrific. Geelong 49, Essendon 45. After the siren, playing only his second game, Jordan Schroeder puts it through. This game promised plenty, and tonight it has delivered. This crowd just catching their collective breaths. Tim, just making the point, we thought coming in it should be a terrific game. Sometimes they don't live up to it, but this one has built.
It has, Dennis. It's been a fascinating first half of football. Quite obviously, the momentum now is with Geelong. I was just waiting for Bomber Thompson to come down onto the ground. He's just about to hit the ground now. He's not as quick or as fit as he used to be. He's taken a long time to get down here. What did you think of that momentum shift about halfway during that quarter?
Yeah, I didn't think it was great. We've done a lot right, and for us just to have a little lapse is pretty disappointing. But we've got another half to fix it up. I'm sure we'll get the game back on our terms.
There's a lot of ball use around midfield, coming through the midfield into the forward line, particularly in that second half of that second quarter.
Yeah, I think we We just wanted to control the tempo a bit more, and we stuck in that phase for too long, and we went sideways, and probably got to get a bit of distance and get it outside your defensive 50 when that occurs.
And will that be the message at halftime, Bomber?
Yeah, be a fair part of it.
You're happy with the aggression and the contested footy in that part of the game?
I think we've matched them there. Yeah. We've been fantastic. Really proud of that, but obviously you can't give any opportunities to the opposition when it's quality of Geelong, so we've just got to do a bit better there.
Again, thanks for your time.
Good on you, mate.
Man who helped build Geelong, 7-7-6-9 at halftime. And if you think 3 minutes can't change your life, you need to see the first 3 minutes of Seven's new show, House Rules, this Tuesday at 7:30. Just recently invented, but it's proving popular. Just checking some numbers. Both these sides have owned third quarters in the games they've played this year. Look at that. For and against Geelong and Essendon. Steamrolling teams after halftime in the third term, and Essendon have gone on with it. They've won every third and fourth term this season, so that is impressive. Let's go down to the boundary. Here's Tim.
Lingy, what about you trying to get some new fans for the Geelong Footy Club? Haven't you got enough here tonight?
Just always doing the work there, Timmy. And as Dennis mentioned about those third quarters, this really is the premiership quarter, isn't it? A huge quarter coming up.
Start of the second half, the opening bounce, the goal after the siren. At halftime, put the Cats in front. High ball comes down towards half forward. Lurking at the back was Hardingham. Schroeder in trouble. Couldn't get boot to ball. Selwood against the flow. In trouble, West. Jabs it across towards Kelly. Hurried kick down towards the attacking 50. Johnson, 18 possessions alongside his name. Not all of them stellar. Picked up by Watson. His 15th. Dug it out in the opposite direction, though. Taken by Enright. Kicks it down towards full forward. Launching behind was Hawkins. He copped one. The ball still in play. Smets looks back and finds a leading Stokes.
Wonderful composure that for a young player, Schmetz, to come out. Quite easily could have just snapped the ball over his shoulder and had a shot, but great composure to find Stokes.
15 gone!
So that kick after the siren, as I mentioned, from Schroeder. Could mean back-to-back goals here if he kicks this without Essendon touching the footy. And he puts it through. Matthew Stokes.
Well, Tom, it was your stat earlier at the start of the match. You know, those consecutive goals that Geelong can kick, and they've done it again tonight.
Between the second and third quarters, yeah. Bruce, and that's five in a row now for the Cats. And the Bombers would have known that going into the game and need to address it pretty urgently.
So a couple to Stokes, Watson out of the centre. They'll really rely on a big second half from their champion. Hurley's been quiet. Good tackle, Taylor brings him down. Wants a free. I think it'll be a ball up.
Straight away.
Have you seen the forward line, Lee, for the Bombers tonight?
Well, they've got the three tools, but really, Cremery's the only one who's actually been dangerous. Certainly, the other two have been held under control, Gumbleton and Hurley.
Selwood, Kelly, Smets, it was clever stuff coming out of the back line. Bagley and also Stokes. And then Stokes just puts the ball over the line, and he's going to be pinged.
Why did he bring it back in?
He just dived over the line, Essendon. Your kick.
It's such a difficult thing, isn't it? I mean, he's in an absolute no-win position. So Bagley, back they go. Hooker, cross the ground. Now they can set up here. Hibbard's on if Myers could quickly get it to. They were two of the stars in that sort of romp early for the Bombers.
Took the safe option there. Bruce actually had Carlisle in the middle of the ground, and it would have been gaining meterage going forward. So playing a bit safe, need to take risks.
That's what's changed for Essendon, hasn't it? Their Geelong pressure's getting to them a little bit, but they're just not playing the ball on. Geelong are in control in this part of the game.
Careless kick by Winterlick, too high for the leading target. Getting in behind, though, is Hocking. Made it okay. Heppel running out of space. Fends off. Hooks it back. Hall and Smith will mark, though. Intended for Watson. Hall and Smith on the defensive 50. Swings it out wide. Bartell leads back in the race. Coming up was Hibbert. Hit his boot, did it go out on the full? Well, the crowd over there think it did. The boundary umpire thinks it didn't. So we'll watch it again. No, the boundary umpire spot on.
Yeah, good call. Bell Chambers, where Selwood, the third man up.
Watson being held. Joe Watson, Essendon free kick, hole.
So the skipper from centre wing, Gee, that's a good arm coming from Stevie J.
It's a big risk because if he missed him by 5 metres, it's probably a 50-metre penalty.
Yeah, well, Stevie J, he hasn't got any problems in that way. But confidence. Hurley, big fly, and big kick to the goal square. Touched. They just need something big to happen, Essendon, don't they? They need a goal, but they need something big to happen just to get a change of momentum here.
Might have been Gumbleton who touched that last one too. Mackey and Podsy Adley. Well, that was a big hand pass, as it turned out. Gumbleton's got it, stood up in the tackle, goes to Davey, to Melksham, vacant goal square, but he swings it well wide.
What the Bombers can take confidence about is their performance in third quarters. They have been a very good side all year, but they've certainly been a good third quarter side, as have the Cats. But they should believe in themselves that they can just get the confidence back.
Smets from behind. Well done by Guthrie to Smets. Heard a voice and goes long with a hand pass. Johnson. Still Johnson over the shoulder. And this ball goes out of bounds. Well, did it? No, he kept it in, according to the umpire. He goes over the other shoulder now. Just a few party tricks from Stevie J. Finds himself in space. Doesn't like that. Needs to be crowded. Brings the best out in him. He finds Stokes on the lead, nevertheless. Feeds it back inside. On the overlap is Selwood. Searching kick inside the forward 50. Brilliantly done. Onto the chest of Hawkins. Geelong looking irresistible at the moment. Sends it long down towards full forward. Taylor in the offensive goal square. Knocked down in front. Motlop had it. Lost it. Too high on Bagley. No free kick. Now Bagley's in trouble. A sea of it. Hand pass came to Zaharakis from Goddard. Now it's with Hibbert. Arches the back. Found a way through. Well, almost. Hand passes to Myers. Myers back to Carlisle. Carlisle to Hooker. Dangerous pass. Hooker drives it up towards the wing. On a lead, Cramery couldn't reel it in. Ball off his fingertips and out of bounds.
Pushed to Cramery.
Well, it's a free kick to Cramery. He disappeared, but the umpire has called it a free kick to Cramery right at the interchange gates.
Hibbert had the right idea there. Took the game on. He took a risk. He almost got brought down, but that's exactly what the Bombers are going to have to do to get back into this game.
Got to be brave, don't they? They've got to take those risks, and here he is. Again, they cross the ground. Now Fletcher. Now the next kick, interesting. He's going to have to go wide though, Bagley, and he does, to Carlisle. A lot of uncontested marks for Carlisle. Now they may be on. Goddard, good with ball in hand. Well, goes bang along, and Lonigan and Gumbleton, but at least they quickly get it from one end to the other.
And courage is often measured by the way you attack the footy and put your head over the ball, but the Bombers need that mental courage to bring the ball into the corridor, take the risky option going forward.
Boundary throw in then, in a dangerous situation, from behind. Blitzarves knocks it down. And the umpire calls for it.
Geelong have been very good at a lot of these, of declaring a non-ruckman as the ruckman and letting their ruckman jump third up. Let's see if they do it here.
A lot of whispering goes on in there. The guy that went up first just drops his arms. There's Hocking, vacant goal square. And it's gone through for a goal. Out of nothing.
So 25 minutes between Essendon goals. They've kicked one goal, six in that time, and Geelong have kicked 5-2. They needed a lucky break. They needed to get some momentum back. Maybe that was the moment. So back to a two-point game. We just feel like Geelong's dominated for half an hour, and yet it's a kick in it. Selwood, Kelly, they're building those two. So is Stokes, such a factor. That kick should be Hooker. Good stretch in the front, though, okay, from Blitzarves. High on Hutchinson. And Hooker knew it.
Good play by Christensen. He knew the tackle was coming, so he just dropped his knees a little bit. Very hard. I mean, you can do it. Have a look at this. He sees the tackle coming. Just drop a little bit. Draw the high tackle.
And the value of a big, honest contest from your tall forward or ruckman there. Blitzarves really had no right to compete for that. He sort of came from nowhere, but brought the ball to ground and resulting free kick.
Christensen kicks the goal. So Stokes and Christensen continuing to be important as small forwards.
Counts by 8 points then, 61 to 53. Hocking's goal, the last one for the Bombers, came after six consecutive behinds. They need something again now. Geelong able to answer through Christensen. Now it's Johnson out of the middle. Surges forward, a very high ball. Going back Bagley. He was protected by Carlisle. Unfortunately, Bagley didn't hang on. Ball spills out of the pack. Carlisle, a sense of humour, fed it back in. Christensen was tackled, couldn't forge his way out of there, and will have a ball up about 25 metres out from the Cats attacking goal, wasting no time, and Hawkins takes advantage of that, thumps it towards the boundary, and now a boundary throw-in, still a dangerous spot. Steve Johnson up to 23 possessions. Knocked down in front by Blitzarves. The hand pass from Hall and Smith charged down. It needed to be Kelly almost through. Hall and Smith trying to back out of the pack, nothing doing.
Dennis, you mentioned Steve Johnson's 23 possessions. He's getting really proactive at the stoppages. On the move every time. The last centre clearances, he's doing it every time there's a stoppage. He's on the move hard.
So Howlett, Butchell just went without it. Comma tries to work it forward. Did well, Comma held it up. Back to Heppel, back to Hardingham, back to Goddard. That's good handball. And then Podziali rips Hedberg and a boundary throw-in.
Give him a couple of centre bounces. Podziali started spare in the back 50, but then he's now he's drifted back in to be on the periphery of this.
Hibbert and Podziali are technically playing on each other. Hibbert setting up as a loose man for Essendon and Podziali for the Cats down the other end of the ground.
And Horland Smith's the one that's tagging Watson, and Heppel's trying to get between them at the moment. Well done, Goddard. They get it out. Under pressure, though, Hibbert kicks poorly, but it was under pressure. And at the moment, it's been played on Geelong's terms. Enright, you feel like the Cats have got a little bit of control over this game. Sets it up to centre-half forward. That's cool. Not a great kick. Gee, Hooker should have held the mark. And then Schroeder off the side and a behind.
Most of the big marking players, apart from when Lonigan's big jump in the second quarter, the ball's just not quite sticking for a lot of those marking players, the tall defenders, tall forwards.
Bring it in now.
Cats by nine. Bagley brings it in. Outside the 50 from behind Hardingham. Stokes going back and finding it. The youngster playing his first game furlough. Gave it across to Johnson. Swings it down towards full forward. Opportunity for Motlop. Stolen away well by Carlisle. In trouble, Hibbert. Just flings it across to Bagley. Clears the zone. Comma got a bad bounce, though. Deflects it in the right direction. Zaharakis fell over, but not before he'd seen Myers grab the football. And now they work it around the outer side. Watson to Davey. This kick bounces its way to Hurley. Now Comma realises not much up ahead. He waits. Puts it back to the man who ran hard and gave him the ball. That's Hurley. Hurley paddling it down towards the pocket. Pursued by Enright. He's trying to get this right-to-left bend. Harry goes back and just helps it across the line. Coerces it across the line and then comes to Stokes. No respite. Guthrie in short finds Duncan, who's been quiet.
And then Duncan, who did kick an important goal on that second turn. Well done by Motlop. Dangerous position, Zaharakis. Handball not good by Schroeder. Hibbert can't get a handle. Watson can in the back. Free kick.
Joe Watson, back.
In many ways, I reckon it's come down to Watson versus Johnson and Selwood.
Yeah, he's been good, Johnson, hasn't he? He's a genuine midfielder, just keeps finding the footy.
Hooker legged. Advantage given. So Essendon with a little chance here. Howlett, can he use it? He does. Windelick has been very quiet. We know he's a good kick normally. And he goes to the pocket and finds his man in Hurley. He's had to work so hard here, Hurley.
That's where you are, Tom.
Just feel like Nick's a good sign from Hurley in this term.
Yeah, he's really attacking the ball, coming at the kicker. It was great patience from Windelick. Then he allowed Hurley, we see there, to play his little trick on the defender, allowed him to work him into the space, and great delivery. It'd be great to go and see him go back and kick this one now.
Set shots tonight. Geelong 7-2, Essendon 3-5. Now, this would be something from the pocket. Not going to be a score, not directly, and a boundary throw.
Yeah, I've seen him kick some really good long left foot goals early from that particular angle. I just thought he might come inside 5 metres and have a go on his non-dominant side.
Bit of Nick Riebold in that last lead from Hurley to back and then forward. Just not stopping, working hard. Wide of the pack, it's Melksham under pressure. Kick is stifled about 5 metres out there by Podziadley. Downward Duncan. Heppel charges in. He's dragged down by Bartell. Comer in trouble. Put down in turn. Litzard's got him and will have a boundary throw in.
He's looked great down there, Podziadley. He's reading the play really well. Setting them up on their forward thrust when they win it cleanly.
Still the Cats by 8 points. Two masters of the third term battling it out right here. Someone maybe about to crack, trying to get out of there was Kelly. Heppel in the opposite direction, bounced off Harry Taylor, comes to Bill Chambers, the high ball, the floating ball, camped underneath it, missing it the first gamer. Thurlow right through his arm, slapped back across the line. And there weren't, in fairness to the Bombers, too many Bombers around that football. Comer pleading his case, a lot of Essendon players, but in the flurry of all that activity, who can tell?
So Bartel goes to a one-on-one. Podziadli, well, he probably could have taken it easier. Slaps it to Lonigan. And then West has to search. Hardingham should be able to turn West inside out. He does. Bell Chambers, Hardingham. Still Geelong matching up pretty well here. They may force a turnover. This will be huge. West maybe not the right guy to try and create there. Essendon need to win it back. Howlett, Zaharakis goes into the forward 50. Hurley, not quite. Little kick coming out for Thurlow. Crash.
Courage you're talking about, Dennis. This is a bloke who's got one kidney.
Yeah.
Backing back. That's as vulnerable as you get on a footy field there with the one arm. And he's copped one in the ribs there too. Terrific contest. They're the contests that are actually going to define this game tonight, the one-on-one contested possessions.
Kick falls in short though. Heppel, who's lifting in this term, comes up, takes the mark. Just under 9 minutes remaining in the third term. Heppel, the high ball, inside the forward 50. Podziadli works his man under it, got a fist to the footy. Behind his end right, hard against the boundary line. Does he keep it in? No. Zaharakis drops the mark, ample time to find it on the deck. Looks inside the forward 50 yet again. Thumped away this time by Taylor. Opportunity in the pack for Selwood. He couldn't control it. Christensen goes down. Tackled brilliantly by Davey. Ball rolls out, picked up by Cramery. He in turn was picked up. The ball comes towards Gumbleton. Smits has got him. Trying to reel it back in Gumbleton. Cramery had the football knocked away by Selwood. Getting it out of there was Duncan. Inside the centre square, taken by Hawkins. Hand passes to no one in particular. Sent back in again by Carlisle on a collision course. Three players met at the footy. Here's a chance for Davey. Davey gives it to Cobber, and Cobber kicks the goal. Oh, how about that?
I think they're wondering whether it hit the post, Dennis.
Oh. I didn't take that into account, Lee.
Scoring review.
Went straight to point for the post. He was the closest player there. He's pretty confident it's hit the post. We'll get a good look at it here.
It's a goal.
Wow.
It's a goal.
The umpire's in a perfect position to adjudicate.
Yes, the ball doesn't look like it changes its sort of its angle of flight. That's one of the things that they go on. But again, if it's inconclusive, it's a behind, because that's been the goal umpire's call.
Wow, what a big call it is too in the context of the game, this one.
Divide the crowd, there's no doubt about it. I mean, you've got to say, from that vision, it's inconclusive.
It's a very inexact science, this, isn't it? This is a good angle, one we rarely get. Umpire's call. You heard from that distant voice, wherever it comes from, an outer galaxy.
So behind a comma, no deviation in the ball, but it would have been a big, big call to say it wasn't inconclusive. But gut feeling when he kicked it, it was a goal. Mm. Goddard. Myers, well done. Heppel has lifted Dennis. And Essendon having a patch here to centre-half forward. No free kick. Gee, got whacked there. Back to Zaharakis, Heppel creating, Goddard, little pokey kick, doesn't get far, Howlett, back to Hibbert, Hibbert having to create, gets onto the left, back to Zaharakis, off a step, again touched off the ball, getting back, Windelick, Windelick's give, Hocking for a second goal, and he misses, they just can't buy one at the moment.
What about the two efforts there by Jimmy Bartel affected the first, Smother went back again to put on that pressure.
It's very hard to actually have a spoil with a bit of contact that's not actually a free kick against, but the umpire thought it was legal.
6-5 to 7-15, they've kicked 1-10.
Out of defence, Johnson to midfield. Duncan spots the runner, Motlop cruises past, goes down towards the pocket. It bounces right on the 50. Selwood tracks it towards the boundary line and cruelly it runs away. shows his frustration. Boundary throw in just outside the 50. Cool as a cucumber. Both of them. West knocks it down. Charging in hard, Hall and Smith gets it across towards Johnson, had the run of it, couldn't control it though. Watson, some champions in there. Hall and Smith glad to be in that company, won the football, slapped out of there by Hawkins. Motlop, half chance in the pocket, and that's all he needs. Oh, that's terrific. Stephen Motlop on the sharpest of angles.
Fantastic, isn't it?
So in this third quarter, Lee, Motlop, Christensen and Stokes have been the goal kickers for Geelong. Three very similar players.
Absolutely. There's a lot of stats in the game. The ability to kick a goal when you have a shot wins you so many games. As basic as that, and that's what's happened tonight, mostly for Geelong v Essendon.
And a lot of their goals are coming from a kick-in within about a minute of a kick-in at the other end. Zarakis put Heppel under the pump. Hocking back to Watson. Watson, well done, kick off a step. It was a terrific bit of vision because he could have blazed.
Yep, that thinking under pressure, isn't it? Just you're under pressure, middle of the ground, just
boys, get out of it.
Just found the free men.
And for all the training now that modern players do, that's the one intangible. That's the one thing that you can't teach, you can't coach, that ability to make sound decisions under pressure.
And this is still the biggest thing in footy, Nick, to kick these goals from 48 metres out when your team needs it desperately. And they just can't buy one. They've kicked 111 since they were 6-5.
It's an old cliche in footy, bad kicking is bad football. And the Bombers, prior to the last goal from Motlop, as Nick said, just had the ascendancy of the game.
Davey's been subbed off, so love it, Murray on.
Bartell to the other side. Johnson camped in front. What a game he's played. Hall and Smith sold Stokes into trouble. Stolen by Watson. He'll kick it. No, he won't. He hangs it out to the right. Even the great ones can't kick the goal.
Ah, the disease, isn't it? We see it so often when you start missing, Nick. There's just the pressure goes on the next kicker. And he misses it well.
No doubt.
In this term, 3-1 to 1-8. Here's Duncan. Just lays it off. Kelly runs himself into trouble. Back to Duncan. Accelerates or tries to get away. Hand passes long. That was his best concession to all of that. Bounced obligingly for Smets. He just eluded the grasp. He goes up towards the wing. Litsavs takes the mark. He's like a rangy colt. He looks inside. Good kick. Hall and Smith goes back. Coming up was Hooker. Tried to knock it away. Tackled by Duncan. Broke free. In trouble. Gives it across to Lovett Murray. He's under the pump. Crashing in was West. Put Heppel down. Schroeder gives a hand pass to Podsy Adley. Can he punish them? Well, the fungus has spread to Geelong boots. He's put it out of bounds in the right full forward pocket.
Dare we say, kicked it like a defender there, Podsy, didn't he? Drifted down and usually sort of put down your glasses when he's 50 out on the left.
You reckon 5 minutes down back does that to anybody?
Absolutely it can.
Fletcher short. It's one goal, as Dennis said, 1-8 to 3-1 in this term. Only in an hour's time or half an hour's time will we know whether they've blown their chances. But in general play right now, Essendon enjoying a good patch. They just can't finish it off. Podsy Adley to West, off a step. Good kick towards Hawkins. A bit of a wrestle, and he's done it again, Lonigan. I just love this flexibility of Lonigan and Taylor going forward.
Well, we've said all night, the predominant forwards haven't been able to mark the ball, but Lonigan's taken his second 15 metres out.
15 gone!
And it just seems they're so preoccupied with Hawkins. Again, Carlo's done really well, taking the front spot.
20.
Prior to that, it's been the Essendon players coming over the top, but Lonigan just read it so well in the air.
So he kicked a goal in the second term in similar circumstances. And gets another one.
This is James Herbal. Lonigan's actually pushed back into defence, I think, so he must have just drifted up again.
Here we go.
3.5 minutes out from three-quarter time. On the way down, Bill Chambers won it. Johnson put the body in, knocked away by Howlett. He's over the football, scampers free. Johnson again. Hand passes to no one in particular, made it interesting. Down goes Myers, could have almost got a free kick. Now Kelly's away, Christensen is in. Motlop is free, confronted, beats his marker, looks towards goal, snaps, and he misses. Oh, what a big chance that was. What a big chance that was.
I'm feeling Geelong off and drop their ruckman back in defence and allow Lonigan to take off.
I reckon also, Lee, they've identified that Essendon do have potential potency is key marking forwards, and therefore any opportunity Geelong defenders got to drift forward,
drag them up,
drag them out.
So Fletcher to himself, and try and kick it as far as he can to centre wing. Bill Chambers and Hook are the targets. Cranmery gets at the back. Still with Cranmery to Bill Chambers, roving for a moment. Now, that's not a bad kick for Watson. If the bounce is there, can Joe kick this one? No, he cannot. It's extraordinary. They've had so many opportunities and just can't finish it off.
I feel like the perceived pressure out there plays such a role in those missed opportunities. It's been so hot for the entire game. When you do find yourself free, you're expecting the pressure to come. You're expecting the contact.
Johnson, 28 possessions now, and a great mark is taken by Harry Taylor. There's no I in team, but there is in Stevie. He's been terrific. There's Taylor, runs inside the centre square, searching kick, angled kick. Lovett Murray goes back, gathers the football, lays it off. Oh, Bill Chambers lets Stokes through. Oh, there's a killer, a haymaker.
Have a look at this, just didn't quite find the target, but great play by Stokes. Not very often you create the turnover and you kick the goal yourself. He's been terrific, Stokes. He's actually been really good now as he's evolved into a genuine midfielder rather than just a permanent forward.
They've got a few of those, Lee, haven't they? Johnson, probably the greatest example. They turned Abbott from one to the other. Great smother. So now it's the equal biggest lead of the night, but it's Geelong's way. Schroeder's kick. They've kicked 9 goals, 4 to 1, 10. After they trailed by 21 points. And Essendon have faced a lot of difficult situations this year, but on the field, this is about as tough as it's got. Duncan's kicked a half forward. Well done by Howlett. And then Howlett, under pressure, kicks out on the forward, but he gets a push and a free kick. I think the biggest thing about Geelong is just the number of contributors they have.
Yeah.
I mean, they're just so even across the board. There's so many good players. It's total football, isn't it?
Well, not many teams can lose the best player probably of the modern era in the last 20 years at least and still go on to win a premiership the next year.
That's a good point. You know, Ablett going, we all thought they were gone when they trudged off the ground in that prelim final. And 12 months later, they were holding the trophy aloft.
Howlett to the interchange gates. Ponzi Adley, a defiant fist. Look out! Oh, well done by both players on a collision course. Young Schroeder can put the body in. Oh, and down goes Goddard a second time. He collided with Schroeder first. He collided with Kelly then. Meantime, back at the game. Schmitz lines up and kicks a goal. Oh, wow.
The three-quarter time break brought to you by Carlton Draft.
Powerful third term coming from the Cats. 6 goals in that quarter. They lead by 27 at three-quarter time. It's 13-9 to 7-18. Matthew Stokes has booted three. Tom Lonigan's booted a couple as well. And Essendon plagued by inaccuracy in that third quarter. Let's go down to Tim and Cameron on the boundary.
Well, Geelong just been super impressive in that quarter, Lingy. All night, I've been so impressed by their two-way running, their sustained pressure. Often Essendon look like they're going to break into some space. Geelong get there in numbers, and then they're so aggressive around the ball too. I don't know that I've seen the side so aggressive around the ball, and then their ability to be able to split and run into that space after they gain possession.
Yeah, absolutely. You can see that defensive pressure you're talking about. It's able to create turnovers, and then three of the players have been absolutely fantastic tonight in that area, but also in their offensive plays. Matty Stokes, Alan Christian, and Steve Motlop just provided that really strong, hard spread from stoppages. They've all hit the scoreboard. Matty Stokes has kicked the 3 goals. Just really, really impressive, the fact that they can do it so well defensively, but then join in the attacking part of the game as well.
Brendan Goddard, 18 possessions, and Lee, reason to be shaken as well.
Well, yes, there was a high shepherd that we saw. I think it was Kelly here in a minute. Yeah, that one. I mean, if he's made high contact, well, let's have a look at it here. What is hard to see? Did he actually make high contact? It was certainly...
It's the jump off the ground, I think, which is the indicator.
I mean, you can lay the contact, but if you choose to bump in that situation and you make head contact, well, then you will be penalised.
And those bumps 10 seconds apart, so, wow.
The Bombers are still in this. You look at the scoring shots from the last quarter, 10 scoring shots for the Bombers, 8 for Geelong. So if they're able to keep going forward and start capitalising on those opportunities, it's important they get the first couple here, but they're still in the game, the Bombers.
I reckon they'd like to have Ryder out there instead of Gumbleton. They could get him in the ruck and get a bit of movement out of the ruck position.
Start of the final term on Friday Night Football. On the way down, it's won by West. Heppel went into the pack. Hocking gets a quick kick down towards half-forward. Connor, did he have the football? Apparently. Enright kicks beyond the wing. Leap at the back from Hibbert. Falls to Goddard in trouble. Frisking him was Blitzarves. Comes across towards Heppel. He's played a great second half. Gave it to Hibbert. Hibbert loops a hand pass into the path of Myers. He runs onto it. Probing kick inside the forward 50. Loose ball at the back. The Bombers needing a goal. The intention was good. Can he kick it off the ground? Hurley, no, he couldn't. Gumbleton knocked it his way. Hurley couldn't capitalise. Mackie comes back to Taylor. Wasn't a mark, but ample time for Taylor. The chip to the pocket. Careless kick. Bartel stops completely. Hand passes across to Christensen. Running out of space. So attractive. Neither's the kick. He kicks it up towards the wing on the bounce, but something good could come of it.
Duncan's kick looks pretty good off the boot. Seward pushed in the back. Gee, that was loose by Hocking because the Bombers were in there. Didn't need to do it. I mean, Seward's been good tonight, but they haven't won off his back tonight, have they? There's been other players. And just think a moment ago, it's easy to be wise, but how handy Davey would have been at the foot of that ball when the ball went forward.
Yeah, it was interesting to get your forward speed. Your main speed in your forward line has been substituted, and they really just look like they've got nothing much at ground level to complement the lot of a big batch of height.
He kicked the first goal of the match, Blitzarves, and he's gone and kicked it. First goal of the last quarter.
They're just crazy the way they play, the Cats. The passage of play across half-back with Bartel and Christensen handballing, flipping it over the top of their heads. Bartel tries a torp, and it just seems to come off for them so often.
Well, Chambers knocked it down. Selwood couldn't find a way through. Johnson chopped off, though, by Comer. Watson shrugs free, under pressure, kicks inside the forward 50. Harry's there. Did OK, too. Found it on the ground, Taylor. Mackie, Podsey Adley. Selwood is on. Selwood will get it on the outer side. Cruising past is Taylor. Taylor looks down towards half forward. Takes something off the kick. Goes to Steve Johnson. Not a bad sort of thing to do, but it's not going to work out too well. Heppel to Watson. Watson kicks inside the forward 50 on the stretch is Gumbleton. And he's taken the mark. Well, that was ambitious in midfield, that kick. Intended for Johnson, but really, it was never on. Should have simply gone down the line and played the percentages.
Yeah, where you are.
I guess this would normally be one of those 50-50 shots, centre corridor. He's going to kick the ball from just inside the 50-metre line. But given
15 seconds.
Their conversion in that third quarter, there's an enormous amount of pressure on his shoulders. Let's see if he can handle it.
Just thinking about what I said, Tom, they're not going to take advice from a man wearing makeup, are they? There goes the kick, Gumbleton. And they answer. They get a much-needed goal. Straight kick, a rarity.
So Gumbleton's goal maybe gives Essendon a glimmer. It's a big, big margin, we know. And
Podsey Adley's started back as a spare defender as well, Bruce, the seventh defender for Geelong.
They're going to be so hard to penetrate, aren't they? It's got to start here in the centre. Goddard, after Hocking helped him, well done, Enright. Poking forward, Hooker, deft little touch to Lovett Murray. Back to Hocking, back to Goddard. Well, one thing we're going to find out a lot about the Bombers in the next 20 minutes.
Oh.
Cranmery, good mark.
Play on.
Watson. And then Watson is delivered beautifully at times tonight. Hurley again in a very difficult position. A couple of his marks have been on the boundary and out wide.
Take his very best from here. Watson again distributing the footy, though.
Thanks.
It's in good hands when he's got it. But even he in that third term, Mr. Couple, you'd probably back him into kick. Off and away after a spate of behind, sometimes the rarest of goals comes along. And this is not a bad effort, just sliding across the face, stretching Bell Chambers. Bell Chambers beside the behind post with a chance to kick a goal here. We've seen as this goal-kicking style has evolved, going around to the right. They've become easier from sharp angles. Let's see what Tom can do. And he puts it through. The evolution of the difficult goal.
Just watch the technique here. It's not the typical lining up 90 degree with a one step, but that's actually a far more difficult kick. You see so many players hit the fat part of the ball and sprain anyway. That was really impressive from the big fella.
So we're back to that 21-point margin that we've talked about a bit tonight.
Hi! Come there!
So that's a famous Selwood move, isn't it? He is so good at it. Getting down low. Kicks hard and high to full forward. Hardingham couldn't quite. Hawkins attacked. Pushed off the footy. High tackle by Schmitz on Bagley. Let's see how quickly Essendon are prepared to move the ball here.
Got to be really brave, Bruce, and take the ball on through the middle of the ground.
Yeah, terrible kick.
Lovett Murray was the target, but I don't know whether he really demanded the ball and went to the right spot. I mean, the kick missed him, I know, but Bartel just looked like he was more determined to get there first.
Well, he's a last quarter specialist. Normally, when they're behind Geelong, he's the one that can make a difference.
He can kick a long ball.
Yeah. You give him a very, very good chance from here. He's got it. Oh, he's the man, isn't he, Jimmy? I know it's opportunistic, but can the Cats win the 2013 flag? What do you think, Lee?
Oh, they certainly can. No doubt about that. I mean, they're going to be seven. Looks like they're going to win tonight. 7-0. Yeah.
Nick?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you've obviously got to win enough games for finals first, but they're over halfway there.
Seven games still to come at Skilled Stadium as this ball comes down towards the 50. All Geelong. Mackey needs all of that time too as he comes out towards the wing, stretching. Litsavs did well to Johnson. He looks inside. Enright goes immediately back to Johnson. Well thought out. He's 60 metres out, pulls it back towards the middle. Smets on the lead. That was classical.
Wasn't that two great players doing two great actions? I mean, that 25-metre handball that found Johnson, he just...
Yeah.
A kick across the body.
Right on us.
Simpatico, wasn't it?
Billy Smets is thinking, I don't mind playing in this side at the moment with those two serving it up.
Every chance to kick another goal here then, Billy. He's got one. Runs inside the 50. Kick is on the way. That's a beauty. Splits the middle.
So Smets with the second goal. Stevie J, 32 disposals. He had 31 last week, 30 the week before that. He is a football genius.
He is. And you speak about can they win the flag. 10 of their players have played less than 50 games tonight, so they're only going to keep getting better as the year goes on. So you imagine the team will improve as they improve.
And you've got Chapman, Varco and Corey.
They're handy.
And a few others there. I mean, Vardy and a few others. So it's a brilliant performance tonight. Kelly's kicked to space and getting back hooker. Short to Fletcher, to Zaharakis, to Fletcher. Important, I think, that Essendon finish this off. 50 against Mackey, so Howlett. This forward line hasn't functioned well for the Bombers tonight. And then Howlett quickly on, not a great kick. Almost cut off by Selwood. Lonigan, Enright, and then Enright with a little deft touch to Thurlow, who was so impressive early.
He looks a player, doesn't he, Thurlow? Heppel, who really lifted in that third term, standing the mark. As Thurlow drives it up towards the wing. Hooker almost again. That's been the story of his night, really. Half chances with those marks, almost. But many of them coming to the deck. He is a good mark normally, but the pressure has been enormous. And the Cats have been prepared to contest as best they can. West has been watching the others. Illusions of adequacy there, just hammering a hand pass forward, but not quite what we saw earlier. Smets, though, the beneficiary again. Selwood, Kelly, not a bad spot for it to space. Coming up was Motlop. He gets the crumb. He's right on the 50. No one is back. He sends it high. Following the footy back is Carlisle. Bounces obligingly for him. Goes to Fletcher in the goal square, confronted. This is a 50-50 ball now, Myers, but they've got four on three. Goddard breaks away, miscues with the kick. Now a chance for Enright. Grabs it a couple outside the 50. Kicks long down towards full forward. Litsavs on the left, boots, and he kicks it behind.
With Vardy in the wings, you're thinking, you know, Litsavs, Podziadli, I mean, They're not going to fit them all in, are they? But Vardy kicked six last week. He's playing his third VFL game this weekend. I know they just rate him so highly.
Rate him really high. It's a bit like the, not the problem, but the challenge the Sydney Swans have. Also, Mike Pike playing such great football when they've got Tippett to come back in. So it's an embarrassment of riches at the minute.
Tom, has Blitzarve's gone past West or not?
Not yet, I don't think, no.
Fair enough, OK. Anyway, it's a wonderful, wonderful problem to have, isn't it? Duncan, Winderlich, hasn't done much tonight. Comma, it's had some moments, not a great handle. Melsham has Goddard out wide, wanted to use him. Bit of a sloppy handball. Goddard with some time. Can he deliver? It looks a good kick. Mark taken by Watson. Has been very good tonight. He's just been overwhelmed a bit by the numbers. The wave, it's like a tsunami wave when Geelong get running. 25, about to have his 26th disposal. If he kicked a couple of goals in that third quarter, but he wasn't alone. I mean, they just had so many opportunities. Those numbers are pretty good, aren't they? He's played well. What does he do? He kicked to the top of the square. He does. Build it away. And the mopping up done by Bartel.
Mackie sends it wide. That's a nice kick. A perfect kick, really. Lonigan been resolute tonight. At both ends of the ground, has put his body in. High ball beyond the wing. Hawkins reaches over the top. Didn't complete the mark. Lovett Murray had it, lost it. Carlisle did well. Down to Myers. Myers feeds it back. Taken on the half volley by Hooker. Goes to Comer. Comer against the boundary line. Goes down towards half forward. Cramery in front. And Lonergan again. That defiant fist.
Scotty's had a good patch, good start to his coach. He came to father a couple of weeks ago, so it's been a pretty good couple of months, Tom, in his life.
He's batting at 80%, Lee.
First child, yeah, that's right, as a coach. Or as a father.
Oh, no. every now and then I keep some good stats, but I haven't got that one. So comment down low.
Just trying to work what constitute 80% as a father.
That's right, yeah.
Let's get back to the ball game, mate. So Comma gets the ball to Myers, and then Myers to full forward. Hurley hasn't been able to impose himself. Little gift to Watson. Kept the ball in, but it might be to Geelong's advantage. And then Mackie just growing in confidence, Geelong, and to Enright.
Podziadli on screen, ran into the goalpost there. That's been a significant win, hasn't it, since midway through the second quarter. Yeah. He pushed back. It's a fantastic athlete. And James Podziadli.
One of the questions I like to ask Chris Scott when he joins us tonight is, when Lonergan goes forward, Podziadli, I mean, are the guys doing that themselves, or is that coming from the bench? Is that a Scott move?
I'd suggest the boys would be doing it themselves out on the field.
Enright towards the wing then. Johnson almost the mark, knocked away by Hibbert. Hawkins had it, it fell at his feet. Schroeder did nicely. Johnson lays it off. Motlop looks across the ground, decides instead to hand pass to Johnson, who's the master of that handball, into the path of Selwood. That time Selwood under pressure as he kicked. It bounces only about 15 metres away. Gumbleton confronted by a much smaller number three representing Geelong, Bartel, and between the pair, they lock it in.
Trying to keep it there. Winderlich, just no one really to kick it to, so he goes back to Hardingham, and that's a sloppy handball. Back to Goddard, and Goddard's little kick not going to come off. Lucky for Essendon as a boundary throw.
That's where I'd love to see Hurley presenting up the ground. Goddard looks up on half back, and there's just nothing to kick to, so he's forced into a scrubby little 15 metre kick. But that's where Hurley can add a dimension to his game, present up, hit the wings, take a few marks up on the ground.
So Hocking belting the ball forward. Here is Hurley. So is that just work rate, Nick, or is it just, what do you think that is?
Well, that might be his role. His role might be to play deep with inside 50 and draw the ball in long, but that's another string to his bow that he can really add.
Gumbleton takes the mark. Lee, do you think Ryder will be in the team next week?
Yes, I would if I was to make that judgment call on the way I see it externally.
So Melsham gets it from Hibbert. And taking Johnson on. Bouncing and then running and then left foot.
Lonergan from behind got a fist on it, although he took the arms or he connected around the scone more particularly, so it's a free kick to Hurley. We'll get this ball right on the 50. Goddard beckoning long, kick goes in that direction and beyond. It's through for a goal. That's a beautiful kick.
So here's the next four for Geelong. They're 7-0. Their first match at Simmons is Gold Coast Suns at home. So They've got Collingwood, massive match next week. Then Port Adelaide, both those, well, Collingwood away, but that's nothing. And then Gold Coast and GWS. They get over Collingwood, they're going to be very heavy favourites to be 11-0. And when they get to 7-0, watch out. Good things happen, historically.
Yep. Remember 2011, they won their first 13, was it, from memory? But they certainly went a long way into the season before they lost a game in that premiership year. Chris Scott took a long time to actually coach a losing game.
Oh. Johnson, Goddard, Zaharakis. So good early, Zaharakis. Wanting to find some space or courage from Heffel and Christensen, Kelly to Sirwood. And then Sirwood handled Mrs. Bartell, Hurley on the up, Cranmery, a real chance here for Cranmery's goal. Essendon get another one. They close a little, that was courageous in the middle.
It's great courage here, just eyes on the foot. He's just impressed the footy world the way he's come into AFL football.
Not even a peek, not even a thaw.
No, it's one of the great parts of our game, that, isn't it?
Yep. Fantastic. And he stayed out there on the far wing.
So, Geelong would like a goal here just to take the heat completely out of the game, but it's likely to be quite heated for the next couple of minutes. The Bombers just scenting it. There's just under 7 minutes remaining. 106 to 94, the attendance tonight. Big house at Etihad Stadium, 53,014.
Fourth biggest crowd ever here, Dennis, and the biggest crowd since that 13-zip game in 2009.
Watson kicks it down inside the forward 50. Hurley in trouble. Well done, Podsy Adley. Worried him out of it. Christensen kicks it up towards the wing. Smith slipped over. Opens the door for Hardingham. Forced to feed it back to Goddard. Some big names involved there. The short one from Watson. Hocking over the top. Melksham in space. Looks up 75 metres out. Long down towards full forward. It was really a nothing kick. Not sure what it was designed to do. And the ball runs through for a behind.
But that's the style of play we've been encouraging the Bombers to bring out for the last two and a half quarters.
And the key target for the Bombers going forward was Michael Hurley, but he just led in the wrong direction. It basically just asked too much of Melksham.
Lost some time there too as the kick comes in. Up goes Taylor. Surely should have got a free kick. Hooker across to Myers. Myers, a left footer, will find himself in trouble there, but played it well. They stayed off him. Brilliant smother by Johnson. He's done it all tonight. Ricochets to Enright. Drives the ball towards the wing. It's going to be a real free kick. Selwood was put down in midfield. Advantage has been paid. Motlop goes to Stokes. Back to Motlop in the nick of time. Motlop couldn't find it. Hacks it out of midair and kicks it across the boundary line. Intended, I think, for Taylor. It was quick thinking.
Joel's your free kick for a block,
okay? Gee, that's a disaster. That was a dead ball. The free kick had already been paid. He's got two prized players going hammer and tongs like that.
It's a nasty dead ball, isn't it? So Bill Chambers getting up. Selwood down low. Bill Chambers. Kelly. Still Kelly. And then Heppel. Windelick. And that ball going to be a ball up. It's a harsh call, I know, but Melksham's had two chances in the last minute. That really, if one of those had gone through for goal, there would have been some hope here. He had to convert one of them. You feel that it's just too big a task. They've done well to get back within almost striking range. Not quite, to be truthful. I mean, it's impossible to see them winning, but they have been able to erode that lead a little. They're on the back foot here, the Bombers. Well done, though. But even better done by Blitzarth. Brilliant by Duncan. Smits sizing it up. Goes to Motlop. So creative, Motlop. And he kicks poorly. He really should have given it off.
He was waiting to draw to give the ball to Stokes, but it just didn't quite eventuate. So he thought, oh, well, the percentage is now to have the shot myself.
Tell you what, he's had a lot of shots on goal for one tonight. He's played very, very well, but he's missed a few.
Stokes has been impressive tonight as a midfielder. He looks like he's got much more run in his legs than I've ever regarded him as an athlete.
It looked a case, Lee, where Christensen and Motlop really burst onto the scene and probably challenged Matty Stokes for that role in the small forward category. So he just worked his backside off over Sunham and got himself extremely fit and can run through the midfield.
Hardingham short of the wing. Umpire, I think, will ball it up. Comma battles with Hall and Smith. So Steve Johnson, 35 possessions, one shy of his career high, 36. He's done that twice. And still plenty of time in the game. Blixarves, hand pass was smothered. Lovett Murray in the direction of Watson. We don't count that one. Oop.
Almost counted that one. Coming through is Stokes. Hand passes forward to no one in particular. Goddard, the pressure still in this game. Melksham goes back to Lovett Murray. Attracted a crowd. Comer throws it on the boot. Short of the wing. Knocked down by Myers. Clears a path for Zaharakis. Now he can go. Zaharakis in two minds. Took too long. Bounces across to Hibbard. Hibbard dances through the oncoming pack. Comes wide to Hurley. Hurley measures the kick. Goes long. Drifting back, guess who? What a player he's been, what a player he is.
And the umpire calling him Boris there, using the nickname. He's obviously been around a while.
Twice best and fairest, both in premiership years, weren't they, Tom?
Yep.
Licksarves gives away a free kick, but we're down to 3.5 minutes now, 107 to 85. Short one comes to Myers.
We know Myers is a good long kick. Can he get this all the way? Can't quite get the hook back, Geelong with the numbers, and that's a disappointing result. They've done a great job, the tall defenders, tonight. When Dennis said, guess who, a moment ago, it probably could have been two or three, to be truthful. He picked a good one with Enright. But they've got so many good sweepers, the Cats, haven't they? I mean, Bartel does it well. The big guys do it well.
Podziadli now, I mean, he's just had another string to his bow late in his career. I'd be able to go and play big defence.
Have we ever seen a more flexible team?
No, well, not certainly the way they've played tonight. They've been up and back.
So Duncan from Johnson. So Stevie J must have got those numbers, I reckon, Ben.
Yep.
And now Hawkins has had a quieter one. But that won't worry them. I mean, if Tommy kicks two and they win by four, well, that's OK. It's only when you get beaten you worry about that, isn't it?
I think, in fairness, Bruce, he had a couple of near misses. He's on 36 now.
So set shots tonight. Cats 11-2, Essendon 6-6.
About 13 scorers to this point in the game. And that's how you love your score to be generated, by a lot of... not goal kickers, but actual scorers.
So Hawkins, who's been kicking two and three all season, hasn't kicked a bag so far, but he's been ticking the scoreboard over.
Oh.
And he's thumped that and hit it hard and kicked his second goal. A little bit of icing on a very beautiful cake tonight. It is a sweet victory. I mean, they have bragging rights right now in the AFL, don't they?
Yeah, they do. They're the team, form team in the competition, and you can't see where their real weakness is. They're just so versatile, so strong all over the ground. They haven't done that well in the clearances tonight, which is a little bit surprising, but I think clearances is one of those stats that are becoming more and more irrelevant in the game.
They don't seem to be leading to victory, Nick.
No, they don't.
They structure up really well behind the ball defensively. And when you look at the Geelong team, and Lee spoke about the triple premiership players from 2007 before the game, it really does bode to structure and culture over personnel.
Yeah.
28 points the margin then. Bill Chambers, patient that time and won it down. Lovett Murray, exit wide. Zaharakis breaks away, goes down towards right half forward. Pitches just outside the 50. Hurley in desperate trouble. Over the top was Taylor. Close to the boundary line, Bartel. In fact, he took it out. Now, Tom, just a question without notice. You were talking about the ruckman that Geelong have got. You didn't mention my man. Hamish McIntosh. Where's Hamish?
Well, he's one of those players where you keep hearing he's a couple of weeks away. Denny's been a couple of weeks away for a long time now, so he's going to come from a long way back, particularly with Vardy playing good football in the VFL also.
He took a step up this week. I was following it in the paper. He was 2 weeks, then he was indefinite, and now he's back to 2 weeks. So I was totally confused, and if any team out there is trying to track his progress, they're confused too. If that's what it was designed to do, Tom, it did.
Well, I dare say he's sitting rank four at the moment out of the ruckman down at the Cattery. Well,
Jared Rivers is the other man that we haven't spoken about. He's the third tall that they've really missed tonight. Obviously, Podziadli's gone back and done the job, but I'm sure they'd prefer to have him up forward.
So, boundary throw-in on the outer side. There's the time remaining. A minute 20.
It's so close to yet another victory in another big game. And their record since round 6, 2007 is unprecedented. It was at this ground. It was Logie's night, actually, when they beat Richmond. 30-odd goals, or I think there were 19 goals at half-time that night. And this is the 150th match since then.
Just in the stoppage, just in how often Geelong have got actually two players going for the hit-out. They're exploiting the fact that the new rule, the ruckman, start a metre apart.
So Hawkins and now Bagley taking too long. Run down by Motlop, who's just so quick.
And Blitzarts, with his athletic background, has obviously got the aerobic capacity to get to
keep a lot of contest. Whether he's the on-ball ruckman at the time or not, he can still get there. Yep.
So in those 150 games since that premiership year of 2007, who Tom sitting alongside me was the captain of the club, they've now won 125 out of their last 150 matches. It's an unprecedented run by a magnificent football team. They've played total football again tonight. Stevie Johnson's been so symbolic of their efforts. And Geelong win the battle of the undefeated. And they take the Bombers by 113-85.
Stevie, it was a really close, hard, intense game of footy early on, but pleasing that you broke them open eventually.
Yeah, it was good, Lingy. We needed to start well, we thought. They got on top of us, but at half-time we were confident. The way we've finished our games so far this year, that we'd have the legs to run over top of them, and we did.
And some of those legs, Alan Christensen, Matty Stokes, Stevie Motlop, were just able to provide a heap of run through the middle of the ground.
Yeah, we've got a lot of guys that can go through the midfield, so that's really helping our rotations and our run later in games. So many options there, and those guys are just improving week in, week out.
And it really does just set up your season now. 7-0 gives you a great launching pad for the rest of the year.
Yeah, it certainly does, but it doesn't get any easier. We've got the Pies next week, so that'll be another big challenge.
Thanks for your time, Stevie. Well done tonight, mate. Over to you, Timmy.
I'm here with Corey Enright. No, a really impressive performance tonight, Corey.
Yeah, it was obviously Essendon on the quality side, and it pushed us right to the end, so it was a good win.
Where did you think you turned the game around in that second quarter? Because it looked like the momentum was going their way. They had a lead at that stage by 21 points.
Yeah, I think defensively we got a lot better towards the end of the second quarter and probably the third quarter, so that probably helped us.
What will Scotty be happy about with this performance tonight?
I think we played it right out to the end, so it's, it was a four-quarter effort. It was a pretty grinding win.
How good was it to see Potts back there in defence with you too?
Yeah, it's really good. Obviously gives us another option, so he played really well tonight.
Amazing start to the season, 7-0. Now really setting yourselves up for a big second half of the year and onslaught in the finals.
Yeah, obviously to 7-0, you wouldn't have dreamed that, but just going to put the foot down now.
Well done.
Thanks a lot.
So the Cats remain perfect, 7-0. They win 17-11 to 11-19 on Friday Night Football. Steve Johnson equaled his career high tonight, 26 running in the midfield, or rather 36 running in the midfield. Steve Motlop, 28. Matthew Stokes, 24. Zaharakis, who was red hot early, finished with 31. So he came back strongly after a quiet second term. Goddard, 29. Watson, 29. 28 was the margin. Geelong's way. Let's go back to Cairns.
Well, Podsy, a bit of a different role for you tonight.
Yeah, look, obviously Jared Rivers is injured at the moment, so once we get him back, we'll hopefully get back up forward. But I enjoyed it down there. Harry and Taylor and Domsey and Mackie really made it easy for me.
Can you tell us what happens in a game? We notice Harry Taylor and tonight Tommy Lonigan push forward to take a few grabs. Do you guys call that yourselves, or does that one come from the box?
Oh, we call it ourselves. We don't want to take any, too many risks going forward. I suppose we're a defence-first side, but when it works well.
Midfield was just terrific tonight. Stevie J led the way again. He's been fantastic through the middle of the ground all year, hasn't he?
He's having a great year, Stevie. And those clearances, I think we got the ball forward more often than not tonight. And that, and Sal and Cal and Bundy in there. Stokes having a great year, so have a keep going.
Well done, Potts. Go work, mate.
Celebrations all round. So much talk about this game prior to it. All week long, the two undefeated sides were being touted around town. Who could win this battle? Well, I mentioned the resume they had coming in. They'd beaten better sides, I think. It looked a tougher draw until tonight, and it transferred onto the ground. And as much as the pressure from Geelong was palpable at times, and the longer it went,
the more you felt that affected the Bombers. Matthew Stokes put it three goals, Hawkins and Smits a couple. And for the opposition, Essendon, really hard for them to find any key forwards. Myers booted a couple, Gumbleton got a couple, but generally it was their little players who gave them most hope. Warm applause from their faithful as they go back into the rooms. They've won some big games. They know how to win big games, and they know how to celebrate big games. The Cats win on Friday Night Football. Song in football, that's not easy to say, but easy enough to sing when you play like they do. They were on song tonight. Comfortable winners on Friday Night Football, 17-11 to 11-19. Plenty more to come. Right.